Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV. It's a Canadian game. Brought to you by Molson Canadian.
It's November the 2nd, 1957, and the Chicago Blackhawks have arrived for an early season meeting with the Toronto Maple Leafs at the Gardens. This is Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV. The Blackhawks are rebuilding and have youngsters Bobby Hull, Elmer Moose Basco, and Pierre Pilote in their lineup. The Leafs have 21-year-olds Dick Duff, Bob Bond, and Bob Pulford out of the Marlboro Memorial Cup team. Hello once again, everyone. I'm Joe Bowen, and welcome to another edition of Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics here on Leafs TV. Both the Blackhawks and the Maple Leafs are in major rebuilding programs to start the 1957-58 season. The St. Catharines Teepees have been a breeding ground for Chicago, with 18-year-old Bobby Hull arriving after Pierre Pilote and Moose Basco. The Hawks have veterans Ted Lindsay and Eddie Litzenberger to help show the youngsters the way. The Leafs are no different, with 19-year-old Frank Mihalovich in his rookie year, along with youngsters Gary Alcorn and Dick Duff, along with Bond and Pulford. The deans of the Disc dormitories tonight are future Hall of Famer Glenn Hall for the Chicago Blackhawks, and for the Toronto Maple Leafs, it's Ed Chadwick. Because we're taking you back to a couple of games from the 1957-58 season against the Chicago Blackhawks, starting November the 2nd. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
This portion of Leafs TV is brought to you by WestJet, because owners care.
Ode to the new Subway Montreal smoked meat sandwich. 6 tasty ounces of smoked brisket and mustard on freshly baked bread, and oh, Canada, you've got a sandwich that can satisfy any appetite. Only at Subway restaurants. Subway. Eat fresh.
Their appearance is deceiving.
It's a robot.
Their presence is a mystery. And on October 16th, the year's biggest adventure...
This thing is wicked.
...arrives on DVD. Transformers, rated PG-13. You can own it on DVD Tuesday, October 16th.
Too cool, keeping them cups of cold is too school. Far from the regular, nothing you used to. Them kind of style is up and school stool. Mind and soul in tune and loose too.
Hello, Moto.
Eddie Litzenberger will lead the Blackhawks in scoring this season with 32. Rookie Bobby Hull will notch 13. For the Leafs, Dick Duff will score 26, while rookie Frank Mihalovich will win the Calder Trophy by scoring 20. James Angus Gerald Mortson was born in New Liskeard but raised in Kirkland Lake and played with that team's Lakers before coming to St. Michael's College in Toronto. As a major, he won 2 Memorial Cups and became property of the Maple Leafs, where he would play from 1946 to 1952, winning 4 Stanley Cups. Old Hard Rock, as he was known, would be dealt to Chicago in the Harry Lumley trade and play 6 seasons in Chicago before finishing his career with the Red Wings in Detroit. Gus Mortson played 797 NHL games, scored 46 times, 198 points. However, 1,380 penalty minutes, Gus. And in those days, you earned them.
No, but I would have qualified for the Lady Bing Trophy the way they played it today.
No, I can't believe that. Someone who got the nickname Hard Rock is probably not going to win the Lady Bing, nor would you have even tried. It's good to have you here. I want to talk a little bit about, really, I guess, the first dynasty that the Maple Leafs had, and this is well before these games that we're going to show tonight when you were a member of the Blackhawks. But the teams from 1946 to 1952 were very, very special.
Yes, they were, yeah. Yeah, we won all the Stanley Cups at the time, and I guess Mr. Smythe wasn't prepared for it, really.
Now, the team that you had, right from the coach on out, you had experienced people and great hockey players.
Yeah, we couldn't have had a better coach, because he coached everybody. I mean, some coaches are good defensively, some are good offensively, but Hap Day was the best every way. He kept the team together, too.
Was he a communicator? Was he a type of guy that would take you aside and do things, or was it done mostly just as a team type thing?
No, he'd take us aside, and if we were doing something wrong, and explain what he wanted, and He showed the defensemen how to keep everybody out of the front of the net, how to leave them sitting on their ass, you know, or something.
I imagine that you paid particular attention to those lessons.
Well, I tried, yes.
Now, Gus, the teams, you've got Apps and Kennedy and people like this who are great leaders, but this team really personifies the type of hockey team that the Leafs had back in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, in that it wasn't an offensive juggernaut. It was a team-oriented, built around good, solid team defense with enough offensive stars to...
It certainly was. There was 1946, just after the war. We had seven rookies that we started with. And we added the eighth the following January when Bill Barilko came and joined the club. And that was a big improvement for our club right there, because here we'd been playing with three defensemen, basically, for a matter of 3 months. Bob Goldham had broken his arm, so he was unable to play. Garth Bush had trouble with his groin, and he was out all the time, so there was only myself and Jim Thompson and Wally Stanowski, who were the backbone of the defense. Well, then, when we got Bill to come, he added a lot to it, to our team, and he really was better than he should have had more notoriety during those years, because he was.
And he was taken from us far too soon. He could have.
That's right.
Been, I mean, he was a very young man when the tragic plane accident. Tell us a little bit about Jim Thompson and the relationship you had with him, because here's another guy that maybe Leaf fans don't appreciate enough of how good a hockey player he was.
Yeah. Well, the first year I played against Jim. He played with the Marlboros in the Junior A here in Toronto. The Leafs had brought him down from Winnipeg, and I guess Jim was having trouble with his schooling and stuff, so he asked Selke at the time if he could switch the following year and go to St. Mike's and play there, because he'd like to get his education improved. So that's where I started playing with Jim, at St. Mike's in Toronto.
Pretty good player?
A very good player, yeah, very solid. He was an awkward-looking skater, but I've seen him in games catch players like Doug Bentley, some other speedsters, and he'd catch them. He wasn't going too slow.
Wasn't going to be pretty, but it got there in a big hurry.
That's right.
Now, Conn Smythe is obviously in charge of this organization, and we're going to talk a little bit more about another incident that you had with Mr. Smythe later on. But what was he like while you were in Toronto as far as running this operation?
Oh, I admired him as a manager and as an owner, I guess you could say. He was very strict on your behavior. You know, you couldn't. None of the players could go around the gardens in a jacket, or you know, in a leather jacket or something like that. You had to be at least dressed properly.
Shirt and tie.
Well, not a shirt and tie so much as, but you had to have you can be no blue jeans. Let's
exactly.
Put it that way.
Yes,
you know what
yeah.
I mean?
Yeah.
You had to be, so. He was good that way. He was honest. I'll say anybody would sign a contract with him without having his signature, because he would stick up to. But he was awful tight.
now tell us.
He watched
every nickel.
Every nickel.
Now tell us the contract story you had.
Oh,
with him.
Well, in '46 we. There was seven rookies that joined the club that year, and he paid all the rookies. I don't know what the others got, because at that time they didn't advertise. But anyway, the six rookies that we know got $4,500 on signing. And then a week after that, the league had a meeting, the owners of the league and everything, and they increased the number of games from 50 up to 60. So Smythe, he made a big show of himself, and he told the seven of us, he says, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. He says, I'm going to give each one of you an extra $500.
What a deal.
For him, yeah. $500 for 10 games.
And instead of...
Instead of $90 a game, it would have been we were going to get $83 a game.
And $7 is going back into Mr. Smythe's pocket.
Now, correct.
When you think about that, and we were asking this, ticket prices?
The most expensive ticket in the gardens at that time was $2.50, and you could buy the program for 15 cents.
And the Grays?
And the Grays, they were 60 cents.
It's changed a little bit, have you heard?
Oh yes.
No kidding. Well, we're going to take Gus Morrison back a few years, back to November 2nd, 1957. He won't be in a Leaf uniform tonight because he'd been traded to the Chicago Blackhawks. He'll be wearing one of the Hawk uniforms. Because you're going to watch Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
My name is Asmir Begovic, and this is my story. Growing up during the war in Bosnia, it became a little dangerous to play outside. So I practiced soccer in my house. I had to play in my room. I was just basically playing against the wall. He got me introduced to goalkeeping in a way which is very unorthodox. I was so interested in wanting to be a goalkeeper and play soccer that nothing was going to get in my way. Some circumstances might be harder than others, but there's always a way.
Love these new chicken fajita wraps from Tim Hortons.
Oh yeah, I love them too. Cheddar cheese, sauteed peppers.
I love your señorita fajita. You're so much, much more than a pita. My beautiful señorita fajita. I love you, mi amor.
Olé.
It's authentic fajita taste in a wrap. Tim Horton's new chicken fajita wrap.
Always fresh, always Tim Hortons.
From director Michael Bay and executive producer Steven Spielberg, the movie event of the year arrives on DVD.
Bring it!
Transformers. Be the first to own it on DVD and HD DVD Tuesday, October 16th.
NHL 2K8 features full 360-degree puck control and authentic signature style for an all-new video game experience.
Hey, Spaz, how's the new goaltending system?
Goalies.
NHL 2K8, rated everyone 10 and up.
We're going to show you two games from the 1957-58 season. Our first is from November the 2nd, 1957, and we're going to pick the action up in the second period. The score is tied 1-1. Bob Bailey has scored from Elmer Moose Vasco to open the scoring at 3:51 of the first, and Barry Cullen from Brian Cullen has tied the game with his fourth of the year at 15:23. So let's now go to action from Maple Leaf Gardens in 1957, November the 2nd, second period.
Hello, Canada and hockey fans in the United States. They've played just on 8 minutes of the second period, a one-all tie. Toronto Maple Leafs 1, Chicago Blackhawks 1. And a sparkling game of hockey right through. The two goalkeepers being outstanding, and the Cullen-Pulford line for the Leafs being the best for the Toronto team, and the Howe and Vasco have been particularly good for the Blackhawks. The goal was scored for the Blackhawks by Bailey from Vasco, a perfect passing play from Vasco, who rounded the net to clear out in front of Bailey. That was at 3:51 of the first period. The Leafs tied it with Chicago a man short. McCoskey in the box, 15:23. Barry Cullen from Brian Cullen. The shots in the first period were even, 7 apiece, 4 penalties, 2 apiece. And it's a one-all tie as the puck is in the Chicago zone to the right. Chicago in the light-colored sweater. The Leafs in the dark blue. That's Bailey over on that far side. Lost the puck. Pulford going in, number 20 there. But it was called on the offside. The referee is Gay Stewart, the linesman Art Scove, and Bob Frampton. Sellout crowd in the gardens. It's a misty rain and mild in Toronto tonight. Montreal Canadiens lead Detroit 1-0 at the end of the first period. Jeffrey on from Beliveau at 10:40 was the scoring play in the first period. The one-all tie here, and the puck is shot on the boards. It's at center ice with McCoskey, number 9, over on the wing to Bailey. He gets squeezed off. Here's another chance. It was offside, called at the blue line. And it's been a hard-fought game right through. Lindsay has been reasonably quiet until a moment ago when he nearly had a mix-up with Mihaljevic, the Leaf rookie. No doubt he's saving himself for that interview with Scott Young during the intermission. He was very quiet up until then. They've played just on 9 minutes of the second period, a one-all tie. A long shot by Mortson. Morrison into the corner, being watched by Skov, 14. Puck is still loose. Now the Leafs trying to come out with Barry Cullen. That's Barry Cullen, who scored the Leaf goal. Now Stewart, number 12. He couldn't get anywhere. And Brian Cullen, 18, shoots it back into the Chicago zone where Mortson's picking it up. He got rid of it to McCoskey. A relay to Mortson. It goes loose on that far wing. Hawks carry it in. A shot caught by Ed Chadwick and thrown off to the side where Morrison, number 3, is doing the dipsy doodle back of the net, as you see there. Takes a good look before passing to Brian Cullen, who's up with Pulford and Barry Cullen, and Mortson broke it up. But the play was called offside anyway, despite the noise from the crowd. Montreal Canadiens lead the Detroit Red Wings 1-0 in the first period at Montreal. And it's a one-all tie here between the Chicago Blackhawks and the Toronto Maple Leafs. And, of course, Rangers shut out Boston 5-0 in the afternoon game. All set now. Hull goes to center ice, number 16 for Chicago. And Murphy is on the left wing, McIntyre on the right wing. Now it's Pilat, 21, ahead to McIntyre, who's rushing in on the Leaf defense. Bond, 21, gets it. Scooped it, but not out. Murphy getting a shot. It hit Rayom, who sprawled on that shot. Sloan comes back on a pass to Kroniker and Harris. Harris, 15, on the boards there. There's Sloan coming in with a pass to Harris. Harris back to the net, waiting to pass in front. Gets it to Bond, who took a slash at it. And the Hawks recover. Here's a two-man break. Hull is with McCoskey as he overskated the puck. The Hawks missed a good chance on that one. Now Hull for the Chicago team across the line. A shot caromed over to Kroniker, who cleared but not out. A shot, oh, just went wide as it was deflected. The Leafs trying to come up. He got as far as center. Pass to the open wing. Rayom slapped it the rest of the way. Hull shot it into the corner for Chicago. And here comes Hull on that far board for Chicago. A pass center to the blue line. Here's a shot by Murphy, and he went wide with it. McIntyre took a shot. It's right in front. And Hull waited too long. That was 16 who missed it. There's a chance there as Sloan went right in front of his own net, as you notice. He ducked back very fast. Now here's Murphy for Chicago to McIntyre. Over with Hull. He gets checked. Puck is still loose. Harris, 15, has it. He couldn't get anywhere. Here's McIntyre's shot wide. Now it's Bond for the Leafs, shooting it on the boards. It's down the far side. Pete Kroniker passed into the corner. Sloan is beaten to it by Pilat. They jam there, as you see, behind the net. Paul had his eye on them all. But there was no further play, and that means the faceoff to the left of the Chicago goal. It's a one-all tie, and now Lindsay is back on the ice with Litzenberger and Nestorenko, Mortson and Thompson, an old Leaf defense now on the Chicago defense. It's an old Leaf combination. Puck is shot down the ice. Lindsay was skating on down to try and get it, but Stewart beat him to it. And that means the Blackhawks are called for icing the puck, and it's brought back for the same faceoff. Mihaljevic, Duff, and Armstrong, the Leaf forward line. Mihaljevic is 27. He's put on quite a show tonight, too. Armstrong gets it back to Morrison. Mortson scooped it. Morrison shoots it right back. Mortson after it. Cleared ahead. It's broken up. Going in, right for Stewart. Oh, and you notice where Thompson deflected that one with his stick. Back of the net again, Mihaljevic trying to center it out. Thompson has him well covered. Nestorenko is moving on the left wing. Left it for Mortson. He didn't clear it out. And it's Duff, 17, a shot. Mortson scooped it. Lindsay comes after it, but is beaten to the puck by Stewart, who cleared it in offside. Day has tied the score for the Detroit Red Wings from Delvecchio and Howe. The time being 2:53 of the second period in Montreal. So it's a one-all tie in Montreal between the Detroit Red Wings and the Montreal Canadiens. And despite the fact the Red Wings were razzed a bit last Sunday by their fans, or some of them, they played show just the same, and they must really be battling in there in Montreal. They'll likely have the full support of the fans before they've played much longer. Puck is rolling out to center ice. Stewart on that left wing gets turned around. It's Duff to an open side. Mortson, number two for Chicago. Here's Lindsay. Right in front of the net, a loose puck, and Armstrong cleared in time. Here's Litzenberger, a shot wide, as Chadwick watched it, but he couldn't make a move, even though it was wide of the net. Morrison took a jolt there from Litzenberger. Here it's out in front of the net. Lindsay couldn't handle it. Mihaljevic knocked it on the side. Duff trying to get away, and he's ridden off by Nestoranko and knocked flat, and there's going to be a penalty. You saw how Duff was spilled on that play. And Nestoranko, number 15, is in the penalty box as a result. So the Blackhawks will be a man short for the next 2 minutes. Duff took quite a while there to get up. Mihaljevic is 27 there. The cross check. 13:26 is the cross-checking penalty when he knocked Duff down. And now the Leafs will have the odd man advantage and the face-off right at the center red line. Stove is out there with McCoskey for Chicago. The Leafs have their power play, and it's the Cullens with Pulford attacking. Brian Cullen to Barry Cullen. Barry Cullen turns back to Armstrong. A shot caromed over the wing. Brian Cullen covered by Pilot. It's against the boards. They couldn't center it out. Pulford was in there, number 20 as well. So Gay Stewart, the referee, marks it for the faceoff in the circle. That's just to the left of the Chicago net. Brian Cullen, number 18. You can just see part of the number. And Skov is the Chicago player. Puck slides into the corner. Vasco Moose does smear the Leaf player Barry Cullen there just to the right of the screen and stop the play again. So the faceoff is in the opposite circle. There's Brian Cullen there, 18, taking a look around, as you see, to make sure everything's all right. There's a loose puck to Mihaljevic, and nice stop by dropping down. Here's right in front again to the blue line to Armstrong. He faked the shot, waited, gets tangled up, over to Brian Cullen. The shot went off Vasco. Now Brian Cullen again. He's moving over to Barry Cullen. They right on the net with Pulford jammed in there, as you see, and Vasco was down trying to cover up on the close-in play. Hall just stood there.
Wendy's delicious 5-piece chicken nuggets combo comes with a drink and your choice of sides, like a baked potato, slow-cooked chili, or side salad for just $3.99 every day. Wendy's, that's right.
As Mother Nature, I'm proud of Mott's Garden Cocktail. 2 servings of vegetables. Zesty, smooth, and surprisingly delicious.
I sure know how to pick them.
Vegetables. I'm talking vegetables. Mott's Garden Cocktail.
All right, the keys to your new car.
Can't wait.
Here you go.
You will bring your car back here for every oil change.
I will?
You will ignore the fact that Mr. Lube is faster, easier, and warranty approved.
Okay.
When I snap my fingers, you will remember nothing.
Who am I? Who are you? What are these things on my face? I can't see! I can't see! Hey, this is a nice car.
Ready for a change?
How much?
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Autoglass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
And now's the perfect time to visit your local Apple Autoglass during the Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway trip for two, or a flat-screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
Now another face-off in the same spot. It's a one-all tie. They've played 14 minutes and 17 seconds. Second period, Nestorenko has a minute and 10 seconds left of his penalty. McCoskey went out of position. Now the puck is dropped. The Hawks get it. Shoot it over the line. Armstrong dumped it across to Mihaljevic to Pulford. Pulford back to Mihaljevic. Back to Pulford. He fell. Then Brian Cullen to Pulford. A backhand went over the top of the net as it ends up in the mesh, and that calls for the stoppage of play. And it's still a face-off despite an argument by the Blackhawk player, Skoll. Face-off is to the left. Of course, he was claiming it should be outside the blue line. The one-all tie between Chicago and the Leafs and Detroit and Montreal Canadiens, a tie 1-1. Pilat, 21, shoots it boards down the ice. That's Armstrong going back for it. He's the first one back. They're watching him. McCoskey came sweeping in there. Now on the far side, Pulford is upset by McCoskey. There's going to be a penalty call, but the play goes on. Back to Barry Cullen. There's back to Pulford. And the Chicago player stopped it, and here goes the penalty. McCoskey had something to say to the referee there. One of those delayed penalties. They had to wait for the Leafs to lose possession, and here comes McCoskey. So now the Blackhawks are two men short, which puts them in a tough spot with the Leafs being at full strength. Bailey from Vasco, the Chicago goal at 3:51, and Barry Cullen from Brian Cullen. 15:04 is the tripping penalty. Tripped Pulford, you saw. Morrison, number three, passed into the corner. Here's out to Sloan, uncovered, and a beautiful save there by Morrison, who went down. Here's Stewart, blazed one, and he's right close. The red light hasn't come on. They all shove around the Chicago net, just like a can of sardines there. That net is 4 feet high and 6 feet wide. You wouldn't believe so many can get that close. They can all get just about in your screen, I guess. They're finally pulling them apart. That's Harris in the middle there, 15. Just about bags on the mill there as they all went storming in trying to knock Hall into the net with the puck. The red light didn't go on and the puck didn't go over the line. Mortson having a quiet talk there. Looking over the situation as Skoll gets a new stick. That's what's holding up the play. Skoll is over at the bench. The tie score, 1-1. Detroit and Montreal Canadiens, one-all tie there. That's in Montreal. And this has been a real spirited game. The Chicago team has improved greatly this year. They're a colorful team, and they're rough and ready in their style. The Leafs seem to be improving as a result of their two games with Montreal Canadiens, splitting that pair, losing the one in Toronto and winning the one in Montreal. So they're unpredictable this year. Puck goes rolling loose. Skoll failed to clear. Here's Sloan, number on the right side, getting it back to Stewart. Stewart back to Morrison. Off to the side. Konecker on that left side. Havishot. Here's Nestorenko returning to the ice. And the Leafs are a one-man advantage. Harris back to Morrison. Over to Stewart. 12. Here's a shot. The defense covered up. Mortson trying to get it away, failed. Stewart in on the right side, a pass to Sloan, kept it in front. Now Stewart again, a shot. Oh, and that went wide as Hall was a regular ballet dancer on that one. And the puck goes back to the Chicago net. Mortson couldn't squeeze it there. They jam against the boards. Nestorenko was in ahead of Harris, a pair of 15s. Mikoski is still sitting this one out. He has a minute and 3 seconds of his penalty left. The 1-1 tie, less than 4 minutes remaining in the second period. Complete change of players. And the Leafs still have a one-man advantage that they haven't been able to capitalize, chiefly due to the fact the Chicago defense has been particularly good in the blocking shots and checking. Lindsay's out there at the moment, number 7. And Nestorenko. So there could be fireworks every time the Chicago player Lindsay is out there. Incidentally, he's the president of the Players Association. He seems to be directing traffic at the moment before facing off. The Hawks got the draw, cleared it out. Mihaljevic goes back for it. That's Mihaljevic taking a good look. Now then, four of them start back. Barry Cullen is on the right. Pulford missed the pass, shot it into the corner. Puck slides back to the Chicago net. Pilot knocked it into the mesh, so there was no further play. There's Barry Cullen standing beside him there, as you saw. All set. Lindsay takes that look. Moved out of position there. You notice Nestorenko came from the side there, offside on the play. He's got to stay on the far side of that small line off the rim of the circle. Players have to straddle that one for the faceoff. Scramble for the puck. Chicago get it, but it's intercepted by Mihaljevic, who skates around, 27 there. His pass was astray, and Armstrong tipped one over offside. You may have noticed he shot it from his own side of the blue line, and it was picked up on the opposite side of the center red line, being an obvious offside. It's a 1-1 tie, and they have fanned 17 seconds remaining. Brian Cullen facing off. Nestorenko lost it. The Leafs are starting to move. That's Pulford cutting it on the right side this time. He was given quite a jolt, and the Hawks just shoot it down as Mikoski has 6 seconds left, and he's standing ready to come on the ice in the penalty box. Now Bond is on the Leaf defense with Rayom. He steps out, and the Hawks weathered that storm and did a good job in holding the Leafs off, first with two men short and then with one. The Leafs didn't have too many good chances while they had the advantage. Mikoski, who was just leaving the ice, getting relief, shot the puck into the lead zone. That's Bond coming out on the right side. He failed to get by Litzenberger. Rayom, number 2. Pulford ahead to Brian Cullen, going up with brother Barry on the right side. There's Barry Cullen over to Pulford. A shot. Wasn't that quite a shot? Perfect scoring play for the Leafs to make it 2-1. Coming from a one-goal deficit. Two Collins and Pulford in on the scoring play. Pulford was the big gun there, and the two Collins get the assists. A perfectly executed play, as you notice. There's no question about the puck being in the net. That makes it 2-1 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Brian and Barry Cullen get the assists on Pulford's goal. So the Cullens are very conspicuous again. Barry Cullen got the first goal from Brian Cullen. ...17:41 was the time. Pulford from Brian and Barry Cullen. And the teams were at full strength at the time. The Leafs had failed to make any impression on the Hawks while they had a two-man advantage, and then a one. Now slow, number 11. He couldn't get anywhere. Murphy shot it out ahead to Hull, number 16 for the Blackhawks. McIntyre going up fast on that side. Morrison took him into the corner. And it's Stewart going back to the net, trying to come out on the right side. A clearing pass. Conacher ahead to Harris. Harris left it for Conacher. And the puck stayed there with Hull starting back for the Hawks. Over to McIntyre. And he was offside. He took that pass on the Leaf side of center ice. Montreal Canadiens have taken the lead. Detroit Red Wings, Jeffrion scoring from Olmstead and Saint-Laurent at 9:34 of the second period. So that's Jeffrion's second goal of the night. He scored both the Montreal Canadiens goals so far. Canadiens 2, Detroit 1 in the second period. And it's 2-1 here for the Maple Leafs over the Chicago Blackhawks. Pilote there, back of the net. Decides to come out on that left side, as you see. He's stopped by Armstrong, who left it for Ron Stewart. A shot goes right in front. Mahovlich missed it. It was a hard one to handle. He gets it again. He's bumped by Hull. Vasco cleared it back of the net. Puck is still in Chicago territory with the Leafs holding against the boards there. And that means the faceoff. Skov to the center of the ice. I just got a look at Carl Voss there, who's watching the game tonight. And the Hawks are called for icing the puck. That's shooting it from one end to the other. So the faceoff will be in the same place. It's Skov coming back for the faceoff. Koski crosses the circle. Have to be on the Chicago side of that line. Here's a shot by Armstrong that McCoskey stopped. It rolls onto the corner. Mahovlich and Thompson going in. Duff from the side is knocked over by Skov. Mahovlich coming from back of the net, centered it nicely, but Armstrong couldn't get a chance. McCoskey failed to get out, and it's Mortson back of the net. Mahovlich blocking him. He tries it again. Bailey is on that wing if he ever gets started. Puck goes loose, checking very close. Mahovlich couldn't get a shot. Armstrong gets it back to Morrison. Over to Stewart, who was off stride. Flicked it into the corner to Duff. Back of the net. Duff back to Morrison. A shot goes bouncing high back to the blue line. Stewart knocked it ahead. And Skov goes back to the net. Clearing on the far wing to Bailey. Back to McCoskey. That's McCoskey there. Coming up over the Leaf line, being pestered by Armstrong, who's going to get a penalty. The referee had his eye on Armstrong there, and Armstrong gets a penalty for hooking the Chicago player right at the end of that second period.
It's cold. It's crisp. It's clearly Smirnoff Ice. Apparently, men have become accustomed to dealing with wet, goopy gels. For non-messy wetness protection, there's Degree Men Ultra Clear, a solid with no goop. Degree, it won't let you down. Men have some interesting ways to deal with the fact gel takes a long time to dry. For non-messy wetness protection, there's Degree Men Ultra Clear, a solid with no dry time. Degree, it won't let you down.
Let's fall in love. Why shouldn't we fall in love? Now is the time for it while we are young. Let's fall in love.
Beautiful new Hyundai Veracruz. We think we know how you'll feel about it.
Over 4 million in prizes. Come into Subway restaurants today to win.
So a lot depends on this game tonight, just what positions they'll be in after it's all over. That's Ted Lindsay now moving. The Hawks have the odd man advantage. Vasco has played brilliantly for the Hawks, particularly in the first period when he rounded the Leaf net to pass in front to Bailey for their only score up to this point. They hold that puck momentarily against the boards, as you see. Off to the side there. The puck is in the corner, and it's Miege covering against the boards, but it's still loose. Referee Gay Stewart gives him lots of leeway on holding that puck there against the boards. He makes sure that it's really frozen against the boards before he calls the play. That's why you notice them there for almost seconds trying to pin it against the boards. Rudy Miege has been used very sparingly for the Leafs tonight. Here's Vasco getting a shot. It's deflected to the corner. Puck slides out, and Vasco, that's Vasco going back to get it, being watched by Miege. Duff is the other forward trying to kill off the penalty, and Lindsay on that far wing, who was interviewed in the intermission there, is right back in form again on the ice. Puck cleared back into the Chicago zone, and Nestorenko is getting underway on the left boards there, number 15. He was boarded there by Stewart, but Stewart was able to hit him far enough away from the boards not to be called for boarding. Puck is taken by Nestorenko again from the corner, back to Vasco. Vasco's shot was stopped by Duff. Lexenberger tried to whack at it. Now here's Nestorenko getting set again, number 15. Back to Vasco, uncovered. A shot went high and hit the glass. Still in there, though, and the Chicago team are putting on real pressure. Here's a shot to the side. Nestorenko hit the side of the net. Puck is still in there, but the Leafs hard pressed. Here's a pass in front. Kasher now is out there for the first time in the game for the Blackhawks. Vasco shot, hit the Leaf player, Ron Stewart, in the face. He went down. There's Armstrong stepping on the ice as Kasher goes in on the right wing, number 8. Puck is taken by Nestorenko on the boards. They are pinning him there, but the puck is loose. A jam here. You see them all right close to that, the end of the glass there. They covered up enough to cause a face-off in that circle. And so the Leafs weathered that two-minute period there of playing a man short. Armstrong having returned to the ice, and there's a change of players all around, as you see, with the both the Leafs and the Hawks taking advantage of a stoppage in play. They're all tucked away there in the players' bench, as you noticed. Now they're ready to go. Brian Cullen for the Leafs. Stove for Chicago. And it's Barry Cullen tipping it out to center ice. Thompson of the Hawks shoots it right back. Chadwick had no trouble catching that one. Rayom is trying to get away. Here's Bond coming up on the right wing to Barry Cullen, to Pulford. He's upset by Thompson. Play goes right on. The Leaf player seemed to be off balance when checked, so it wouldn't be called a trip. And Brian Cullen on the far side there, being watched by Scove. He pulled away from him. Cuts right through. He's hounded by Mortson there, who had his arm around him. Here comes the penalty. Mortson seemed to be holding him. And that's going to be a Chicago penalty. There may be an argument once this circle in front of the penalty box, in case anybody wants to go over that line, it's a misconduct penalty. Mortson is in the box. Mortson is off. That's Gay Stewart, the referee, number 14. Mortson of the Chicago team is off for holding. 2:54 is the time of the penalty. And now the Leafs have the man advantage. That was Cullen and Skov facing off together, and McCoskey played it safe by shooting it down the ice. Mihaljevic going back for it behind the net. Brian Cullen cut in front of him, takes the pass. Here he's moving fast up to Barry Cullen. Right on the left here. They're all up inside the line. Mihaljevic goes in for a bad pass. It's behind the net. Barry Cullen back to Armstrong on the point. He hit his own teammate. Here's back to Mihaljevic at the blue line. The shot, it hits Skov. It's going loose. Skov cleared it. And it's down the ice with Brian Cullen going back for it. Ryan Collin, number 18. He's the center player and will be the pivot of the line. Now they're moving up four of them up across the line. Ryan Collin in possession. Thompson stepped into him but fell. Armstrong is covered by McCoskey on that far side. He fell. Here's Pulford getting a chance. He was upset. And Skov shoots it at center and it hit Mihaljevic. And the Leafs are down again with Pulford. Thompson turned him around. And the Blackhawks are really leaning on some of these Leaf players. Good, solid checks. Chicago shoot it down the ice. Mihaljevic, 27, going back of the net. The Leafs in the dark, blue. Chicago in white. Mihaljevic at center. Two of them with him. He left the puck, picked it up again, flipped it into the corner. Thompson is covering against the boards, cleared to Nestoranko, who shot it off the opposite boards. And Stewart is going back for it as the Leafs change on the move, as you see there. Here's Stewart coming up, weaving at center. A shot goes wide off a skate. Nestoranko is covered by Harris, an upset. Pulford gets in there, and they're jamming with two Chicago players, you see, sitting down. It's Thompson and Nestoranko. Thompson was 5, Nestoranko was 15. Now Vasco is coming out to replace Thompson. Score is 2-1 for the Toronto Maple Leafs over the Chicago Blackhawks. They've played just on 5 minutes of the third period. And Mortson has 3 seconds before he returns to the ice. 3-1 for Montreal Canadiens over Detroit. Mortson's on the ice. Chicago at full strength. Puck is in the Chicago zone. They shoot it down the ice. They'll be called for icing. Nestoranko cleared it. That's Morrison touching it. And that means the puck will be brought all the way back as the Chicago team was at full strength. So the faceoff is to the right of the Chicago goal. And Hall, who is going for a little skate by himself, as you see there. But he's had plenty of action and has been doing a particularly good job along with Chadwick and the Leaf Nets. Pilon on the defense now with Vasco. Hull, the junior brought up this year by the Chicago Starry player, is quite a solid citizen out there, along with Murphy and McIntyre. The Leaf player was upset, but he tripped over Murphy's stick. He seemed to step on it more than being tripped. Now Murphy trying to get out. Sloan is sticking with him, number 11. He's helped out by Harris. Vasco gets into it with Sloan. They're against the boards, having a regular stick duel, and then they pin that, as you see, against the boards, and then the referee calls it for the faceoff. 2-1, Maple Leafs leading, but it's still anyone's game yet. That's Pete Conacher, son of Charlie Conacher there, number 16, playing his first game after recuperating for some time with a bad knee. Now then it's McIntyre to Hull, broken up. Pilot takes over the attack for Chicago, intercepted by Stewart, coming back with Harris on his left. Stewart passed, went wide. Murphy, trying to get away in the left wing, is thrown off stride, and Stewart, 12, takes over. Stewart lobbed a pass to Harris, 15. Harris pulled away from Murphy, tried to go in, the loose puck. And Murphy takes it to the side, flipped one to Vasco, down the wing. The big defense player comes over the line, passed back into the corner to Hull, who's given a jolt. McIntyre centered out, it's deflected. Stewart failed to clear. Murphy centered in front. It rolls right to the goal, as you see there. And Chadwick went down on one knee and covered up with Morrison standing inside the goal crease. Thompson and Mortson on the Chicago defense. Here's Mortson getting a chance. It's stopped by Bond. Puck is still loose. Mortson after it again is knocked down by Duff. Bailey gets ready. His shot hit the Leaf player. Rolled in front. He's in the goal. Skov got the loose puck to tie it up. Good clean effort in front of the net there. Skov was Johnny on the spot and was able to hook it into the corner of the net. He was covered on the play, but he did a great job there in hooking it across into the Maple Leaf net, as you saw. So it's now a 2-2 tie. Bailey will certainly get an assist on the play, and possibly McCoskey, but we'll have to wait to see. Skov got the goal and did a lot of work to get it, too. So now it's a 2-2 tie.
Chicago goal, scored by Skov, Bailey, and McCoskey.
Yes, Bailey and McCoskey. 6:59 is the time of the tying goal for Chicago, making it a 2-2 tie. Skov from Bailey and McCoskey. Teams are at full strength. Mortson coming up now, and the pass was offside. There's Mortson over there mixing it up with Bond. Maybe something doing. Better take a look. It's over by the boards there near the blue line. They're breaking it up. They're all in a huddle there, ready to start. But it broke up just as quickly as it started. It's a 2-2 tie here with the Chicago Blackhawks showing plenty of fight and ability to come right back and tie the score. Now Bond, 21, is back of the Leaf net. To the corner to Rayom, number 2. Over on the far side to Armstrong. A relay to Mihaljevic, coming down with Duff on the left wing. Duff tried to kick it over the line, as you saw, and Thompson recovered. Starts Skov off on the left side, and Bond rode him out. It's Armstrong going back for the loose puck, making a rink-wide pass to Rayom. Rayom is trying to get underway. It's being watched as he comes down the left wing, number 2. Crossed the line. Left it for Duff. A shot went wide. Thompson is watched by Mihaljevic. Over to Mortson in the corner there. Chicago in white. Leafs in the dark blue. Skov scored that last goal. Failed to get away. Mihaljevic back to Armstrong. He took a whack at it there, but Mortson blocked it very neatly. And Mortson has been stopping a lot of good shots. The Hawks shoot it down the ice. They'll be called for icing the puck. Puck goes to Vasco, a greatly improved defense player and very colorful. He's known as Moose, and he's a giant. And he set up a perfect goal for the Blackhawks in the first period, going end-to-end, rounding the net, passing right in front, and Bailey was standing there and tipped it right in the net. That was the first goal of the game, and an excellent effort all round. The Leafs came back with a goal to tie it in the first, took the lead in the second, and Chicago have tied it up in this third period, which fairly represents the play. Lindsay went in there with Stewart covering him on a long clearing pass. There's going to be a penalty called when Lindsay went down. The argument goes on to watch this circle in front of the penalty box. If anybody steps over that line, they get a misconduct, and Stewart is in the penalty box. And no one dared step over that line because a misconduct now means $25 fine. And that isn't hay. So Stewart is off for upsetting Lindsay. Tripping penalty. 9:06 is the time of the tripping penalty to Ron Stewart of the Leafs, upsetting Ted Lindsay. And they have a change coming out here. They haven't quite decided who the Leafs will have on the ice. Lindsay is skating over to the bench. The Leafs are standing there, not knowing just who they're going to send out. They're arguing about the captain of the Leaf team. That was Armstrong arguing that last penalty, but nothing happened. Now Miguet's out there with Armstrong with Morrison and Bond on the defense. Ted Lindsay has the puck back of the net there, as you see. There's Litzenberger over to Kasher. Kasher at center. Vasco's on the left side. Leaf player Morrison was knocked over. It's a pass right in front of the net. Morrison scooped it high. It rolls down the ice. A race for it. There's Miguet. A shot. Oh, a hot one. Oh! It went into the net. Crowd roar. That was a sizzler that Hall knocked him over. And that goal was scored with the leaps of Van Short, Ron Stewart being in the box. Rudy Miguet blasted one at Hall that knocked him over, and the puck rolled into the net. The time is 9:33, I believe. We'll just wait and see. Morrison got the assist. Rudy Miguet went all the way, though, and it was his blazing shot that scored to give the Leafs the lead for the second time in the game, 3-2 now. And the Hawks had a man advantage at the time and still have. There's Morrison sailing into the boards when upset by Nestoranko. But it was a clean check, and the two of them really fell into the boards. They covered up so there was no further play, but they're playing it really on the rough side at times. Leafs still shorthanded. There's a pass back to Thompson, over to Mortson. Shot failed to go very far, and Vaughn shot it down the ice. Miguet comes roaring to the attack. He's number 14. Now Morrison down the right side. Oh, what a smash as Morrison bumped in him. Here the right in close. And the goal was ridden off to the side. Morrison bang, and the puck goes off to the wing. The Hawks are really tearing in here. The puck back to the net. Miguet covering up. Over to Armstrong. Armstrong on the right wing. Away, but Lindsay beat him to it. And knocks the puck back to Thompson of the Hawks. It's a rink-wide pass. Mortson is watched by Miguet. That last scoring play, Miguet from Morrison at 9:33 with the Leafs shorthanded. Stewart has 25 seconds of his penalty remaining. 3-2 for the Maple Leafs. Here's Litzenberger, one of the Chicago greats, going in there, a loose puck. And Nestoranko following, goes to the corner, clears back to Thompson at the point. A long shot goes to the corner, centered in front, off to the far wing, and Pulford shoots it away. Ron Stewart standing there, stepping on the ice. Now the Leafs are at full strength. Thompson starting out slowly. On that left wing, a clearing pass on the right side to McIntyre, who overskated momentarily, with Stewart going in behind his own net. Stewart, number 12, fed a pass to Brian Cullen, 18. To the defense, a shot wide. Hull trying to get away and stopped by Barry Cullen. Vasco bumped into Brian Cullen, knocked him over. That's Vasco behind the net. Then Murphy is covered. Here's a shot. Oh, and it took a crazy hop and went over the top of the net. Paul didn't know just where that was going. And the puck went over from this side into the crowd. So there's plenty of action all the way, going both ways. 8 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the game. Toronto Maple Leafs leading 3-2. A lot can happen yet. It's a real good hockey game. Puck rolls to the Chicago defense. Vasco, 22 there, taking his time, as you see. Pass on the left wing. Hull failed to get out. Pilot shoots it off the boards and slapped back by Rayon. Pilot bringing it back again. 21. Over on the wing. Brian Cullen lost it to Hull by passing to his on his stick. Vaughn having difficulty. Back of the net there. Brian Cullen, 18. Stopped. Whacks it. Then gets it across. And Barry Cullen goes up with Pulford on his right. Pulford going in, right in front to Barry Cullen, and the shot went wide. Pilot and Brian Cullen with brother Barry all along the boards there. And the face-off in the circle to the right of the Chicago. 3-2 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Change of players all around. 1-1 at the end of the first, 2-1 for the Leafs, end of the second. Chicago tied it up, and the Leafs took the lead again when they were shorthanded. Here's a shot by Morrison. Hall got a skate on that nicely. Pilot ahead to McIntyre. off Hull, who tipped it from center ice into the Maple Leaf zone. Stewart, 12. On the far side to Sloan, Hull blocked him. Here's a chance, a shot over the Leaf net. McIntyre, 11. Over to Hull, 16. Back to the net. That Hull is a nice hockey player for Chicago. He's just a youngster, but he certainly plays like a real experienced veteran. A loose puck at the Leaf defense here. McIntyre trying to get in front of Hull. A scramble. You see how close that was. Now on the wing. And the Leafs come down with one man back. Stewart going up with Harris. There's the shot. Nice save by Hull. And ended up in the corner there with Stewart being blocked by Vasco. So they're changing again. The pace is telling on these two teams. They've been going wide open. And they have 6.5 minutes remaining. The Hawks there changing. Just going into the bench. And now Harris faces Skov of Chicago. It's Sloan, a backhand off the boards. Thompson on the defense with Mortson. It's out to McCoskey, away offside. That pass came from the Chicago side of the blue line and was picked up on the Leaf side of center ice. Do it all over again at the blue line. The Leafs are using Harris, 15. Conacher, that's Pete Conacher, son of Charlie Conacher, number 16. Sloan on the right wing. There goes Mortson for Chicago, number 2. He's weaving in nicely. Here's his shot. Oh, and Chadwick kicked that one out neatly. Skov flipped it to the corner, back of the net. It's Morrison leaving it for Conacher. Conacher down the left side. Rolled one off a skate out to center ice. Now Sloan turning. Showing a lot of speed, but he's being watched by McCoskey. And it's Conacher on that left wing that went in ahead of the puck carrier to nullify the rush.
This is Quiznos Beef and Swiss Melt on Garlic Bread, one of the many options available at Quiznos for dinner. Butcher quality seasoned roast beef, real Swiss cheese and mushrooms on garlic bread. Do you need a moment to wipe the drool from your chin?
Quiznos, a cut above.
This Friday, the greatest sports movies of all time are going down.
Nothing can stop this kid!
The Comebacks starts Friday.
300, two behind the leader. Perfect distance, and just to the left of the green. This is a very tricky shot. Good speed, right at it.
Don't just watch it, live it. Experience the ultimate in high definition with LG Full HD. LG, life's good.
Do you want to practice like a Leaf? Your team can win a chance to experience an on-ice coaching session. The Leafs practice from the bench and a tour of the Maple Leaf dressing room. Log on to MapleLeafs.com and enter your Denon product UPC code. Practice like a Leaf.
Need auto glass repair or replacement? Visit Apple Auto Glass during our Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway for two, a flat screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Apple Auto Glass. Canada's local auto glass experts.
Litzenberger is ready for the face-off for Chicago, number 12 there. That's Nestorenko posing number 15. Puck rolls to Mihaljevic. He failed to get anywhere. Armstrong, 10. Back to his defenseman, Rayome. Intercepted. Nestorenko couldn't get past center. Now Pilot shoots the puck into the league zone. And the Chicago team are giving fair notice. They're going to really moved to the limit the last 5.5 minutes here. Try and get at least an equalizer. Now it's going in front of that for Armstrong. He cleared it out to Duff. One man back, Vasco in the corner. Duff gets it over on the wing of Mihaljevic, right in. Oh, and a beautiful save by Hall, who sprawled and got the edge of his stick, as you noted, right to the corner there. Mihaljevic seemed to play it perfectly, but Hall was letter perfect too. So it ended up a tie there by not going in. Just got the edge of a stick in front of that shot. Well, it was a flip, but it was along the ice. Litzenberger facing Mihaljevic. Jay Stewart ready for the face-off. Players on the rim of the circle. All set. Lindsay went out of position there. Tried to beat the gun. Now Mihaljevic moving in. Nesterenko gets that puck going back of his own net. 15. Has kind of a leap of style. Good skater. Left the puck for Thompson at center. A rolling pass over. It's knocked out. And the Leafs are trying to cover their checks to hold the Chicago team off. Less than 5 minutes remaining in the game. 3-2 for the Leafs. And it's Mortson back to that net again to Thompson. Back to Nesterenko, over to Lindsay in the corner. Lindsay to Nesterenko, didn't see it. Armstrong turning at the blue line. Backhanded a pass, and Bond has to go to get it. Bond takes a long shot. Hall steered it to the side. Litzenberger fed a pass that Rayon stopped. Litzenberger all again to center. Going in over the line. Dangerous rush, a pass. Duff knocked it down. Duff to Armstrong. Nesterenko sticks with him. And Mortson comes up with the puck. Over to Lindsay. Lindsay tearing in, is knocked down. Vaughn covered up. There's Lindsay going after Duff. And Duff shot it over on the far side to Mihaljevic. And it's still in the lead zone. Armstrong trying to get out. Mihaljevic takes the pass and bounced off his stick. Mortson goes back for Chicago. Back to Litzenberger. A drive hit Rayon. Here's Nesterenko in front. And Mortson was waiting for the pass, and the Leafs ahead to Mihaljevic. 27 down the right board. He's going in on goal, and he was checked nicely by Thompson. Now there's going to be a penalty called against Mortson. The slashing. Now then, watch that rim of the circle in the penalty box. You see how obedient they are. Step over that line, and you're out $25. Slashing penalty. Mortson. There's Mortson ready to do battle with the spectator. He's doing a lot of talking there in the box. He threatened to get up after a goal.
Well, a bit of an incident between our guest, Gus Mortson, and the major, Conn Smythe, at the Gardens. But let's preface this a little bit as to why this kind of happened. Yeah. At this time in the history of the National Hockey League, Ted Lindsay and others, including yourself, were in an effort to create some sort of a players' association. Possibly to get you more than the $90 for those, for those 10 extra games they added to the schedule. But take us back to that, Gus, and meetings that you had in order to try and get this off the ground.
Well, Ted, he wasn't able to get an answer from the pension society as to what kind of a pension we were going to get. It was just... After the 10 years, we'll find out and we'll be able to tell you. But we were, so it, Ted also says, well, there's other things too we'd like to speak to them about. For instance, if you got traded during the year, nobody paid your expenses. If you had your family in one place and you were playing, you were traded, the club never gave you any reimbursement for going from one place to another. So we thought we had a few more complaints anyway. So we did get together. He got a representative from each club, and we had a meeting with our lawyers in New York. They were the same lawyers that the baseball had acquired, and so we thought, well, they're used to sports and stuff like that. We'll get them. So we had our meeting in New York as to what we would do, and then we gave the instructions to the lawyers to notify the owners
that we had an association, and it was confirmed. So, well, I guess when the owners got this information and stuff, the first thing...
Well, that went over well, I'm sure.
Oh, I guess it did. The first thing they wanted, they said, okay, we'll have a meeting, but we'll have a meeting in Florida. And I believe it was in March, I think. It might have been when the playoffs were over or sometime. But it was March or April. And we met down in Florida, and we had this meeting. And this is where I ran into Smythe the first. I mean, I knew him before, mm-hmm. but I mean, on this basis,
became antagonists.
Yeah. So anyway, we were all in there, the players' representatives and the owners of the club, where they were all there, and we were in this one room, and it was one long table, and I had the unfortunate place of being sitting at the end of the table, next to the end of the table, and I had been given the script to read what the Players Association wanted one by one as we went down, and guess who was sitting right beside me? Conn Smythe, and he is the spokesman for the owners. He became very quickly thought he was still a major in the Army, and he was going to lead.
All right.
So every time I
get out of the way,
right? Every time I said something, he didn't care about the other guys. He just looked at me, and he red in the face and start yelling at me and telling me that we can't do that. We can't do that. We're not going to do that, you know. So now
you come to, you're in Chicago.
Yeah.
And in the incident that we've seen after killing off the two men short situation and everything else, you do take a penalty. Yeah. And tell us what went on here as you went to the penalty box.
Oh, as well as I went in, got in the penalty box, and all of a sudden, there he is right behind me, and I can't figure out why he was three rows behind me when ordinarily he had a box in the front row greens, and he sat up there. But I assume he must have had some people that he had invited, and he was sitting with them. So he told me, I could hear him yelling, you know, and take it to your lawyers in New York and all this, you know. So I stood up and I said to myself, or I said, the major, and I gave him the salute, you know. nothing derogatory about it.
It was a full salute. It wasn't like the one finger salute or anything
right,
like that.
Right, that's what I mean.
Exactly. You showed a little bit of respect. Anyway.
Right.
But it was a difficult time, obviously. And Jim Thompson paid for it as far as being traded away from Toronto because he was the representative
that's
here.
That's right. Well, anyway, even Todd Sloan the following year was traded also to Chicago, partially because of... I don't know if he took over for Jim, and because he did that, and then there was that's what happened with Smythe anyway.
And Ted Lindsay, of course, in Detroit, he's dispatched.
Well,
to Chicago
yeah, but
as well.
He got dispatched to Chicago, yeah, and I don't know what happened because I guess it was maybe 6 or 7 years later. He turns around and he's the manager for Detroit Red Wings.
So he's sitting on the other side of the table again.
Yeah, he's sitting on the other side.
Well, that's a bit of Maple Leaf lore as Conn Smythe is saluted by Gus Mortson on us in the penalty box at Maple Leaf Gardens back on November 2nd, 1957. We're going to go back to more of the third period here from the Gardens.
And still 3-2 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Now Mortson is still in the penalty box, really riled up. Ready to go, and the Leafs have the odd man. Here's a shot by Pulford, went wide. Morrison getting ready with a drive, didn't get it away. He stands near the line, Pulford going in. A shot, Paul steered it to the corner. It's Skov shooting it down the ice, Stewart going back for it. Paul has scored for Detroit from Godfrey and Burton at 9:10 of the third period. So Montreal Canadiens lead 3-2. And Detroit making quite a battle of it in Montreal. You see Seem to be getting better every time out, and no doubt any time now they'll have the fans really hooping it up in Detroit. 3-2 here for the Maple Leafs over Chicago in a very hard-fought game and very even. Morrison at center ice, over on the wing to Pulford. Leafs have the odd man. Thompson blocked him nicely. Puck is in the corner. That's Barry Cullen, 19. Back to Morrison, number 3. Is it Barry Cullen? A flip over to brother Brian. Hit the side of the net. Brian Cullen is down on the ice with Pilot, 21. So the faceoff will be to the left of the Chicago net. And now a change of players all round. It's 3-2. Toronto Maple Leafs leading. And Mortson is still in the penalty box and has 59 seconds of his penalty left. He's standing up in the box even though he has almost a minute to go. On the left wing, Morrison on the board. McCoskey watching him into the corner to Sloan. Sloan waiting, trying to get an opening over to Morrison at the point. A pass is knocked to the side. Ron Stewart into the corner. Pete Conacher gets set and shot one over the other side. Morrison of the Leafs, number 3, standing there. They're trying to draw a check out of position, get a man loose, but they haven't been able to. The Hawks have been checking brilliantly. McCoskey knocks that puck to center ice, goes tearing after it, and Harris beat him to it. Stewart comes back. The Leafs on the move. Conacher carrying that puck ahead to Harris. Going in, Harris shoots, and Hall grabbed that one and threw it to the side. Conacher back to the point to Morrison. Morrison stands there. Over to Conacher, deflected one. Thompson knocked it back in the corner. Morrison's back on again. The team's at full strength. Sloan centered it out. It goes loose to Morrison. Morrison trying to break away. He was hooked there by Stewart. There'll be a penalty likely called on that one. And as soon as the Leafs touch it, there's a hooking penalty. Stewart of the Leafs hooked Mortson and is going to the penalty box, as you see. Stewart for hooking. And they have 5 seconds left in the game. The Leafs lead 3-2, but the Hawks will make it really hot here, and Hall may leave the ice. 18:55 is the time of the penalty. It's likely that Hall will leave the ice as soon as the Blackhawks can clear it into the Maple Leaf zone. That's just to the right of your screen there. It's Hall at center ice with Lindsay, Nestoranko, Litzenberger, and Vasco out there for Chicago. Miguet, Armstrong, Morrison, and Vaughn for the Leafs. The puck is back at center. Litzenberger rolled it to Nestoranko. Nestoranko going into the corner. The pass is stopped by Miguet, who flipped it down the ice. Litzenberger going back to get it. All the way back behind his own net to regroup the Chicago forces. 45 seconds left. Lindsay on the move. Left it for Litzenberger. Going to center ice. Every man up. Here's a shot. Deflected to the corner. Morrison took his man to one side. Vaughn knocked it on the boards. Vasco centered it out to Litzenberger. Shot! The goal! The Hawks have tied it up again on Litzenberger's shot. Whether anyone deflected or not, it's hard to say. But Litzenberger's shot appeared to go into the net. We'll have to wait and see whether there was any deflection on the play. But it was a desperate effort there. It looked like Litzenberger for sure, but they were all jammed around the net there. And now it's a 3-all tie with 27 seconds left, and Stewart, of course, returns to the ice. Litzenberger appeared to get the goal all right. Yes, he gets it. Vasco and Hall. 19:33 is the time of the tying goal. Second time the Blackhawks have tied it up. So it's a 3-all tie with Stewart off. And now he's back on again. The team's at full strength, and the puck goes into the Chicago zone. Mortson passed ahead on the wing. Letzenberger tipped it ahead at center ice. It goes down the ice with Stewart shooting it back to the net to Armstrong. Armstrong coming up with Migue. Armstrong at center ice, and he failed to get his shot away. Lindsay carrying back, and the game is over. And the Blackhawks, with a real comeback there, were able to merit a 3-3 tie on the game. But it was a thrill from start to finish.
Their appearance is deceiving.
It's a robot.
Their presence is a mystery.
Why Earth?
To take over the universe.
But on October 16, their arrival on DVD will transform your world. Transformers. Own it on DVD and HD DVD Tuesday, October 16th.
I've been saying some controversial things about Molson Canadian. I've asked about this alleged true Canadian taste and wondered if it's brewed by Canada's oldest brewery. Does that really matter? Now, overall, people haven't reacted well. But the people here have treated me with respect and admiration.
Thank you, Alberta!
Thank you! I've enjoyed your meat!
There's only one true Canadian taste, Molson Canadian Lager.
Do you want to practice like a Leaf? Your team can win a chance to experience an on-ice coaching session. The Leafs practice from the bench and a tour of the Maple Leaf dressing room. Log on to MapleLeafs.com and enter your Danone product UPC code. Practice like a Leaf.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
And now's the perfect time to visit your local Apple Auto Glass during the Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway trip for two, or a flat-screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
In the third period, Glenn Skov scored his third from Bob Bailey, and then Rudy Migue of the Maple Leafs got the Leafs the lead again before Eddie Litzenberger from Vasco and very young Bobby Hull tying the game at 19:33, and that's how it ended, a 3-3 tie. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
It's cold. It's crisp. It's clearly Smirnoff Ice.
My name is Asmir Begovic, and this is my story. Growing up during the war in Bosnia, it became a little dangerous to play outside. So I practiced soccer in my house. I had to play in my room. I was just basically playing against the wall. He got me introduced to goalkeeping in a way which is very unorthodox. I was so interested in wanting to be a goalkeeper and play soccer that nothing was going to get in my way. Some circumstances might be harder than others, but there's always a way.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
And now's the perfect time to visit your local Apple Auto Glass during the Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway trip for two, or a flat-screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
Don't blink, or you'll miss it. 50% off all lenses with any frame purchase at Lens Crafters. Even bifocals, no lines, and prescription sunglasses. So don't blink. Hurry in before November 17th.
Gus Mortson is our guest, and a veteran player by this time, four Stanley Cup champions under your belt, and a great, big, strong bull of a youngster comes out of the St. Catharines team, the farm team, to play in his first game ever at Maple Leaf Gardens on November the 2nd, but to go on to a tremendous career, Bobby Hull. What was your first impression of this big kid when he arrived in Chicago, Gus?
Well, he didn't seem as big as what he was. he was still growing, you know.
He was only 18.
Yes, that's right. And he really hadn't fully developed. But after he came with us, he fitted in very well. And his first full season, and I believe in his first full season he went to school because he had 16 goals, I think, in his first season, first full season. Mm-hmm. After that, his scoring abilities went right up over, he was a 20-goal scorer.
And then became a 50-goal scorer.
And then he became a 50-goal scorer,
Was there evidence at that point that he was going to be able to shoot the puck as hard as he did later on in his career?
Not really, no. No, I wouldn't. Everybody, I think, was able to shoot the puck harder, really, than from that time. In those years, 57, 58, we were still with a stick that had very little curve to it.
Mm-hmm.
If any at all. To go to the curved stick, when I grew up, we had it up to about 1940. We had a curved stick because it was a one-piece wooden stick, and it had a curve, and you could always bend it some more if you wanted it. And we actually had a harder shot at that time than the years from 41 to about 1959, I'd say it was just around 59 or 60, that they then brought the stick out with the big curve. Mm-hmm. And fellas found out that they could take a blowtorch and you could make the curve a little bigger. So
they did.
And it did.
Yes, it did.
And it would it increased the speed of the puck tremendously.
And made goalies decide that masks were a pretty good idea at the time.
I think so, yeah.
Now, another big guy that is on this team is Elmer Moose Vasco.
Right, yeah.
And he's a young kid at this point, too.
Yeah, that's right. Well, except Hull came in about 57.
Yep.
And I think Vasco, he came to training camp and started in 57. Mm-hmm. But I think Bobby was about halfway through the 56-57 season that he joined us from St. Catharines. You know?
But Vasco would turn out to be a very rugged individual, too,
yeah,
and a big
yeah,
man.
He was not a rough player, though, but he was. Moose was a good puck carrier and a good, very good skater.
Well,
excellent. Yeah.
It's fun to see these guys in their infancy in the National Hockey League, and Gus Mortson is part of the Blackhawks as the Leafs and the Hawks finish in a 3-3 tie on November 2nd, 1957. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
This is a very tricky shot. Good speed, right at it.
Don't just watch it, live it. Experience the ultimate in high definition with LG Full HD. LG, life's good.
Rib Rageous is back at Boston Pizza with a classic rib dinner and chicken and ribs, both with garlic toast, Caesar salad, and side dish for just $16.95. Boston Pizza. You're among friends.
Introducing new peanut-free Mars Dark. Filled with delicious nougat and caramel, it's Mars. Only darker.
This Friday.
Nothing can stop this kid!
Offsides. Cheap shots. And hard knocks.
Violence is not the answer!
The comebacks starts Friday.
Do you want to practice like a Leaf? Your team can win a chance to experience an on-ice coaching session, the Leafs practice from the bench, and a tour of the Maple Leaf dressing room. Log on to MapleLeafs.com and enter your Denon product UPC code. Practice like a Leaf.
We're going to fast forward now to February the 22nd, 1958. Also part of the 57-58 season. Same two teams are back at Maple Leaf Gardens to tangle with Toronto, and we're going to pick up action in the second period after Bob Pulford had scored for Toronto, his 12th of the year from Ron Stewart, and Ed Litzenberger from Hull and Vasco has tied the game in the second period for the Chicago Blackhawks.
Hello, Canada and hockey fans in the United States. A one-all tie as Cullen goes in with a shot. Right on there as Hall made a great save. It's a one-all tie. Very hard-fought game. Very close. The Leafs scoring first. Pulford from Stewart and Masnick at 17:28 of the first period. And then Chicago tied it up. Litzenberger from Hull and Vasco when the Leafs were shorthanded. Here's a chance for Hull. And his pass to Ferguson went wide. Off the corner there, the play is called. And there's going to be a slashing penalty called by referee Lou Ferrelli to the Leafs. Pulford. And Pulford is going to the penalty box for slashing. That's the third Leaf penalty in this second period. Chicago have had one. Pulford is 20. And the time is just past the 12-minute mark, 12-8.
Leaf penalty, Pulford. 2 minutes for slashing. Time, 12:07.
12:07 is the official time. Pulford for slashing. Masnick was off in the second period when Litzenberger tied the score at 3:55. That was Litzenberger's 23rd goal of the season. Pulford had scored for the Leafs 17:28 from Stewart and Masnick, and that was Pulford's 12th goal. Now Vasco, 22, is going back. The Moose is behind the net, as you see. For Chicago, the Hawks in white, the Leafs in the dark blue. Now the Hawks with the man advantage, broken up at center by Barry Cullen. Brian Cullen is not in the lineup tonight. And Sloan is also out, as well as Duff. The Leafs have Bob Nevin, who's played several shifts, and Brewer, who has not been on the ice as yet. Brewer is the defense player from Marlborough. Nevin is a forward. Puck is cleared into the Leaf zone. There's Masnick going in there behind the net, trying to get away from Murphy, who blocked him. Hilott cleared over off the boards. Nesterenko is trying to get an opening. Here's the shot by Pilot and was stopped by Morrison. Masnick shoots it off the boards and relieves the pressure. Litzenberger had rounded Morrison to score on a fairly long shot while Masnick was off. It fooled Chadwick. It was a low shot, a very good one at that. There were four penalties in the first period with the Hawks getting three of them. Now here's Vasco shooting one right in front. It deflected off Murphy's stick. Nesterenko getting a bounce again. He's been a marked man. Morrison failed to clear it out. Now Masnick lost the stick and kicked it out with Vasco blocking it at center. Morrison knocked it over the boards between the two benches there, right near the exit.
I've been saying some controversial things about Molson Canadian. I've asked about this alleged true Canadian taste and wondered if it's brewed by Canada's oldest brewery. Does that really matter? Now, overall, people haven't reacted well, but the people here have treated me with respect and admiration.
Thank you, Alberta!
Thank you! I've enjoyed your meat!
There's only one true Canadian taste, Molson Canadian Lager.
Before we go back to second period action, let's check in ringside with Sheila McTaggart. Sheila.
Hey, guys. Every other game prior to this one, the Zamboni driver cleaned the ice in a clockwise direction. But now, he's cleaning the ice in a counterclockwise direction. Now, no word yet as to whether this is a random event or part of a bigger strategy to try to change the game's momentum. Back to you.
What do you think, Bob?
Okay. Good move. Good move. Smart.
Introducing new peanut-free Mars Dark. Filled with delicious nougat and caramel, it's Mars. Only darker.
My name is Asmir Begovic, and this is my story. Growing up during the war in Bosnia, it became a little dangerous to play outside. So I practiced soccer in my house. I had to play in my room. I was just basically playing against the wall. He got me introduced to goalkeeping in a way which is very unorthodox. I was so interested in wanting to be a goalkeeper and play soccer that nothing was going to get in my way. Some circumstances might be harder than others, but there's always a way.
It's endless shrimp. The only time of year to enjoy all the irresistible shrimp you can eat. All of your favorites are back, plus new buffalo shrimp. It's endless shrimp for a short time at Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today.
Maple Leaf Gardens have completely sold out for this very important one. And it's cold and clear in Toronto tonight. New York Rangers lead Montreal 1-0 in the second period at Montreal. That goal was scored by Bathgate from Creighton and Howell at 13:34 the first. Now then the Hawks with Martson coming down that left side. He's cutting in on goal. He left a loose puck in front. And the Leaf player, Alcorn, shot it away with Thompson, number 5, clearing it back of his own net to Kasher, 8. There's Pulford stepping on the ice. The Leafs are at full strength again when starts a rush. A clearing pass to center ice. He's dumped by James. Kasher was knocked down, but there was no penalty, and it keeps right on going as Harris went for a slide before knocking the puck to center ice, and they have 5.5 minutes remaining in this second period. A 1-1 tie. Chicago Blackhawks 1, Maple Leafs 1. Here's Harris getting his shot. Hall knocked it to the side. The Leafs have had more scoring chances than the Chicago team, but have failed to capitalize. Frank Mihaljevic particularly having about 3 good chances and missing them. Once he had the open net in front of him. There's James, number 16, failing to barge his way through. The Hawks clear it down the ice with Dineen going after it, and the Leafs cleared it right back to center. Here's Thompson. Shot went over the line with Stewart cutting in front of his defense. That's Stewart clearing it out to center to Alcorn. Moving with James on the right wing. The shot goes wide. James tried to barge in on Mortson. Puck is rolling around in the Chicago zone. Now out to center to Morrison. Morrison, number 3, shoots it in again offside. The referee is Lou Ferrelli. Matt Pavlich and George Hayes, the linesman, a change all round. And in the afternoon game, Detroit Red Wings defeated Boston 6-1 and did it very handily. This one's a very tight, close, hard-fought game, almost playoff hockey. And the Leafs play another very important game tomorrow night in New York against the New York Rangers. The Leafs have 3 games in hand over the Boston Bruins. There's a shot wide of the Leaf goal. Horton is on this line with Armstrong at center ice. Mihaljevic on the left wing. Pilot covered the Leaf rookie. Two prize rookies are out there, Hull of Chicago and the Maple Leaf star, Frank Mihaljevic. Hull has been held fairly well in check, and Mihaljevic has missed a few good chances. Now Vasco, Lemieux, goes and clears the puck back to Pilot, who couldn't get it. Mihaljevic took his shot. Hall had no trouble, and Hull, trying to get away from his check, is stopped by Horton. This is a line with Armstrong, Horton, and Mihaljevic. Hull goes down the left side, was well covered by Vaughn. Rayom into the corner, trying to get away, shoots it back of his own net. Into the corner. They jam there. That's Ferguson standing by with Litzenberger, 12, away from the corner.
Grammy Award winners and international superstars Maroon 5 are back, and just in time for the summer heat. Their highly anticipated follow-up album, It Won't Be Soon Before Long, includes the smash single, Makes Me Wonder. Maroon 5's hot new CD available at Best Buy and online at bestbuy.ca.
You invested in early mornings. You invested in the proper equipment. You invested in goals and dreams. You invested in moments that will last a lifetime. And you invested with TD Waterhouse. Because we know life is an investment with great returns. Whether you do it yourself, want someone to work with you, or have us do it for you, we can help. TD Waterhouse. Wealth of experience.
Rated M for mature.
Don't blink, or you'll miss it. Your new look for winter, on sale right now at LensCrafters. So don't blink, or you'll miss 50% off all lenses with any frame purchase, including bifocals, no lines, and prescription sunglasses. Check out our stylish selection of frames for a whole new look that will make everyone else blink. Hurry, 50% off sale ends November 17th.
As there's Armstrong 10 facing off, and Bond came into the circle to knock the puck to center ice. Vaskill cleared it back to Hull, who's going the wrong way. Now he's turning. That's Hull. His clearing shot was blocked, and it's still at center ice. Ferguson shoots it in. Puck is back of the net with Raome to Bond. Bond to Horton, who didn't see it. Pilot blocks it at center, trying to pass to Hull, who's forced to the far side. Hull gets it back to Vasco. Vasco on the move, around Armstrong, shoots it, and it hits the linesman who was sitting up on the boards there by the Chicago bench. It's a one-all tie with 3 minutes and 1 second remaining in the second period. Tightest kind of a hockey game. The Leafs scored first, and Chicago was 1-0 for the Leafs. End of the first. Pulford from Stewart and Masnik. The goal coming at 17:28. Teams were at full strength. Now Raome on the move. A long shot. Hall had no trouble with that. Litzenberger back of his own net is covered. There's Vasco. Shot it down the ice. Vaughn is going back to get it. It's up over the line. And it's called by linesman George Hayes. Called for icing against the Chicago Blackhawks. A one-all tie. Litzenberger getting his 23rd goal of the season. Pulford his 12th. The Hawks changing. Vasco the last one in, 22. Face off to the left of Hall in the Chicago zone. The Blackhawks in white. The Leafs in the dark blue. And that's Masnik, number 8. Facing off. He's the eager beaver of the Leafs. Mortson tried to get out there from the corner. Quick pass to Skull. Back to Nestorenko. Nestorenko trying to come over. Does, but you notice the right wing there. Skull offside. He went over. He was drawn over when he thought Nestorenko was going to zig instead of zag. Masnik and Skull facing off. Skull is 14. Pulford leaves it for Stewart, over to Morrison, back to Stewart off the boards, and Murphy over to Skov. They're closing in. Nestorenko shoots, and that was close as the Hawks moved in very quickly to take advantage. Here's Murphy from the side, back in front, and the shot was wide as Nestorenko was hurrying. Nestorenko dumps it into the corner again. Leafs trying to cover. Barry Cullen lobs it down the ice. Thompson is going back and can get it, so it won't be called. That's Thompson there. The next Leaf went in front of his own net. Skove trying to clear, couldn't. Cullen shoots it into the corner. It's Masnik back of the net, trying to center it out. They're jamming quite a bit. The puck is in the corner. Skove, here's a fight. Mortson and Pulford. Now they're all getting into it. Pulford and Mortson were the two that stood off. They're trying to get at each other again. Mortson's number 2. You can see him in there on the screen, and that's Pulford 20. They were the two that started the fuss. The others all started shoving, but there were some fairly hefty swings that didn't land. That's Pulford to the left of your screen. Masnik is just standing in front there. Skove is figuring it all out. 14.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Auto Glass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
And now's the perfect time to visit your local Apple Auto Glass during the Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway trip for two, or a flat-screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
Hey, cheerleader, how are you doing? Doing well? Gonna get it? I'm doing well.
I'm well, thanks. You?
Business is booming. Lots of clients, lots of places to send things. I gotta be ready for anything. Do I hear a huge new client on the West Coast? Lots of stuff, lots of places. Surrey, Sudbury, St. John's. A little nervous. Okay, lots of nervousness.
Hey, boss, how you doing? I'm crazy. Everything moving. Coffee later. Let me know. I'm gonna be here all day. Cheerleader, good to see you.
No problem. Talk to you soon. Anyhow, back to you. I gotta get all this stuff to locations all over Canada. Can you do it?
Tomorrow 9 a.m. guaranteed.
Sold. I'm gonna.
When you ship with Purolator, out of the ordinary is never out of the question. Purolator, where business is going.
High-def action like you've never seen. Only on Panasonic Viera Plasma.
Here's Mortson just coming across, all ready for action with his gloves in his hand. That's Gus Mortson coming over the penalty box. Matt Pavlich, the linesman, skating with him as escort. There's Mortson in the box. Now here comes Pulford, and they have to sit it out together. Wolford and Mortson off together. And the time is a little less than a minute and a half remaining in the period. Then they decide to get them out of there so there won't be any further trouble. Mortson and Pulford are going over to the dressing room instead of sitting the minor penalties out in the box. So they'll cool out in the dressing room as the linesmen watch the two of them go. There's Pulford 20 just going out of sight.
Mortson, 2 minutes for high sticking, 2 minutes for roughing. Leaf penalty, Pulford, 2 minutes for high sticking.
They're fighting in the car. Can you see them? They're putting on quite a sideshow there, Mortson and Pulford. Now the players are all going out to see what's going on. But they went at each other when they were getting close to the door of the dressing room. So that was a behind-the-scenes episode. The two of them went out. They each get double minors, apparently, for high-sticking and roughing, and they likely get more as a result of that blow-up. You see how the other players are quite interested to see what's going on, and they're causing quite a jam in the exit where the two dressing rooms are. Farther on is the television studio right at the end of that aisleway there, and that's where Tom Foley is going to interview Turk Broda during the intermission, so he may have had a better view of it than the rest of us. In the meantime, there's Hall, unconcerned, not paying any too much attention, and Chadwick just as disinterested, while the other players return to the ice to start the last minute and 28 seconds approximately. So they each get double minors, and what they'll get for that extracurricular fight in the aisleway out there, we haven't heard. We'll give you that later. There's been no announcement about it. Puck is cleared into the lead zone. Morrison is stopped back of his own net. The puck is loose, and it's Stewart going behind his net, clearing to the open side, and Barry Cullen knocked the puck to center, where it's grabbed off by Ferguson. 1 minute left for Litzenberger, trying to go in there and couldn't. Now the Leafs on the move with Stewart, clearing it out to center ice. Masnik gets a jolt from Pilot. Cushioned clears over on the wing to Litzenberger. Masnik took it from him, goes in himself, couldn't get a shot, was held on the play, and there'll be a penalty to the Blackhawks, Pilon. And he's objecting very strenuously.
Okay, that's fine.
What's wrong?
My presentation. I left it on the plane.
You what?
Okay.
Okay, don't panic.
Oh, hey, Mr. Weeks. Just so you know, your presentation's up. I've printed hard copies for everyone. I made a slight adjustment to the outlook for the first quarter. Oh, and I ordered sushi for lunch. See you on the flight home.
Thanks.
Why do WestJet so much? Because we're also WestJet owners.
Hey.
Hey.
All drive?
Nah, we'll switch when we need gas.
The surprisingly fuel-efficient Dodge Caliber.
Better hurry if we're gonna make that show.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Maybe you guys should go on ahead without us.
You sure?
Yeah, we'll catch up.
How did you know which wire to disconnect?
Ask your doctor if Cialis is right for you.
Want proof that Polaris makes the world's toughest ATVs? Take the all-new Sportsman X2 800. 800 cc's of muscle, electronic fuel injection, a dumping cargo box. Tough, tough, tough. But what makes the Sportsman X2 twice as tough for the competition to beat is that it changes from a one-up to a two-up ride anytime, anywhere, without any screwing around. Sportsman X2 800 from Polaris, the world's toughest ATVs.
1-1 tie, and, well, there's been a little excitement. You created most of it here at the Gardens on this night, Gus. You and Bob Pulver get right at it, not only on the ice, but off the ice.
Yes. You notice that now they separate the players. At that time, everybody was into the penalty box, and there was a Chicago player, a Toronto player, a Chicago player, and when there was four of us in there, there was set pattern.
Sure. You know? Yeah. Now, was there a lot of chat that would go on in there?
Not too much. Not too much. Unless,
and what precipitated all of this with Pulford then?
I would think I would think one of us hit the other one and didn't we really didn't settle it right there. We were still settling what we started out on the ice,
and then into the corridor,
and then we got into the corridor. That was it was the second time I got into a fight in the corridor. The first time it was with what's his name this year for New York? He was the coach.
Not Reggie Fleming.
No. Coach. He was the Reggie player.
Oh, I'm trying to think. But with this kind of a thing.
Yeah.
Are the police running around after you and everything now?
No, not necessarily. No, they weren't. No.
Somebody
just got in there to break it up. That's all.
Now, it's interesting. Bob Pulford's going to end up being one of the first presidents of the association that finally comes into place, and here you are fighting with him. He's also going to be a management guy, too,
that's all about.
As far as Red Sullivan.
Yeah.
Is that the fellow that you had the fight with in the corner?
No.
No. That was, or Phil Watson?
No, it wasn't Phil Watson.
Well, we're running out of names.
The two brothers.
Well, we're still running out of it. We'll figure it out as we go along. But here's an opportunity now with... really, the league then settled things on the ice, didn't it? I mean, it was self-policed.
I've been watching the games, you know, that go on. And what happens, the referee, there's a fight on the ice starts. The referee, he sits back and he looks at what's happening. The two linesmen, they don't make a move. They don't make a move today until one guy is either knocked out, has his teeth knocked out, or has... cut or something like that, and they got to break it up. If you look back at the time we were playing at that time, the referee sat back all right and watched. But the two linesmen would get right in there right off the bat and break it up. And you can't hit a linesman, so I don't know why they are getting afraid of they're going to get hit or something.
I guess.
Because it automatically, if you hit a linesman, you're out of the game.
One of the other aspects that I found very strange, and yeah. I had completely forgotten about, was photographers jumping on the ice and taking pictures of things going on the ice. If it was a fight or a brawl, you'd see photographers wander out there with their cameras and they're shooting pictures.
I guess so, that's right.
One of them didn't get popped. Well, at any rate, we're going to take you back now to more game action from February the 22nd, 1958. The Blackhawks and the Maple Leafs in a rough one going on at the Garden.
It was a combination of hooking and holding on the play, and Pilot is the player that gets the gate. 21. So he's in the penalty box.
Chicago penalty, Pilot. 2 minutes for holding.
Now that holding.
1925.
Pilot off for holding. And they have 35 seconds left in this second period, a 1-1 tie, and there's a lot of feeling in this game and a lot of tension. Here it's back to the blue line, over to Stewart. Stewart gets his shot wide. Over to Raume again. He stands there, gets ready, pass to the side to Mihalovic, who centered it in front. Skoll shoots it down the ice. The Hawks playing 4-5 as Stewart, 12, goes back to the net. Now the Leafs on the move again. Mihalovic down the left side with Armstrong going in on the right. The shot bounced in front of the net. Goes to one side where Thompson covered up as the bell ended the second period.
It's endless shrimp. The only time of year to enjoy all the irresistible shrimp you can eat. All of your favorites are back. Plus new buffalo shrimp. It's endless shrimp for a short time at Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today.
It is a cold, crisp, clear day down there, folks. Minus 12. You might want to bundle up.
Why do WestJetters care so much? Because we're also WestJet owners.
Here's a question. What do you like best about being up here?
Well, that's easy. I love the view. I love seeing all the places that people have to go. I love being part of the company that helps them get there. I mean, who put the first tires on the moon?
Our guys.
Who saw erratic weather patterns happening and developed a Goodyear triple tread tire with three different tread zones?
Our guys.
We said, if the road wants to play rough, we're putting the strength of DuPont Kevlar in every silent armor tire.
Boy, now you're talking.
I love the fact that we're up here looking out for everybody down there. What about you? What do you like best about being up here?
Well, I like seeing all the games. And, you know, all that stuff that you said.
Innovative thinking up here, so you can get there. Goodyear, get there.
Rated mature.
Well, our crack security staff and our research staff of Paul Patsko and Mark Askin have come up with it. It was one of the Patricks.
Yep.
Muzz?
Muzz Patrick, yep.
And he suckered you.
Oh, yeah. That was coming off the ice. It was in the hallway right there, and he let me have it.
And his explanation?
His explanation was, he says, I just look at Mortson and I got to hit him.
And he was a boxing, an amateur boxing champion, too, and here you are taking shots from him. Now, Gus, I wanted to ask you a little bit about watching Frank Mihalovic, because he's in his rookie season as well this year, and here's a guy that is going to win the Calder Trophy this season, and he and Bobby Hull have, for the next decade, a running battle as far as who is the best left winger, and of course, fans of either team would argue until they were blue in the face who was better. Frank Mahomet, what was he like to play against?
Oh, to play against. Well, he was a good skater. Tough to outskate him. He wasn't a rough player, but he was a player that if he went to take you out, he took you out without trying to put you into next year or something. You know what I mean?
Big long reach, though, as a defenseman, that would have had to have been a problem, too.
Well,
trying to contain him because of his size.
Yeah, well, they can all be contained, you know. you got to learn how to stop them, that's all.
And you learned, I know, there's an awful lot of people. 1,300 minutes of penalties is one way to stop them. Well, the Maple Leafs and the Chicago Blackhawks are tied 1-1 after the second period. Eddie Litzenberger has scored for Chicago and Bob Pulford has scored for Toronto. We'll be picking up action in the third period. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
I've been saying some controversial things about Molson Canadian. I've asked about this alleged true Canadian taste and wondered if it's brewed by Canada's oldest brewery. Does that really matter? Now, overall, people haven't reacted well, but the people here have treated me with respect and admiration.
Thank you, Alberta!
Thank you! I've enjoyed your meat!
There's only one true Canadian taste, Molson Canadian Lager.
Grammy Award winners and international superstars Maroon 5 are back, and just in time for the summer heat. Their highly anticipated follow-up album, It Won't Be Soon Before Long, includes the smash single, Makes Me Wonder. Maroon 5's hot new CD available at Best Buy and online at bestbuy.ca.
All right, the keys to your new car.
Can't wait.
Here you go.
You will bring your car back here for every oil change.
I will?
You will ignore the fact that Mr. Lube is faster, easier, and warranty approved.
Okay.
When I snap my fingers, you will remember nothing.
Who am I? Who are you? What are these things on my face? I can't see! I can't see! Hey, this is a nice car.
Ready for a change?
How much?
Need auto glass repair or replacement? Visit Apple Auto Glass during our Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway for two, a flat screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Apple Auto Glass. Canada's local auto glass experts.
NHL 2K8 features full 360-degree puck control and authentic signature style for an all-new video game experience.
Hey, Spez, how's the new goaltending system?
Goalies.
NHL 2K8, rated everyone 10 and up.
Gus, Rudy Pillis, what was he like as a coach?
He had good coaching system. He wasn't particularly one that took a player and used him to the best advantage. He wanted to mold him to what he thought he should be, and he made it difficult for a lot of players.
He was successful, though, as the last time Chicago won the Stanley Cup would be about three seasons after this.
That's right.
I guess you couldn't argue with it too much.
No,
but you're right.
Argue.
A lot of coaches would do that. They would not necessarily see the talent. They would try to mold it into their own form.
Right.
All right, well, the Blackhawks and the Maple Leafs. We're going to go to third period action. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
Ode to the new Subway Montreal smoked meat sandwich. 6 tasty ounces of smoked brisket and mustard on freshly baked bread. And oh, Canada, you've got a sandwich that can satisfy any appetite. Only at Subway restaurants. Subway. Eat fresh.
Before we go back to second period action, let's check in ringside with Sheila McTaggart. Sheila.
Hey guys, every other game prior to this one, the Zamboni driver cleaned the ice in a clockwise direction. But now, he's cleaning the ice in a counterclockwise direction. Now, no word yet as to whether this is a random event or part of a bigger strategy to try to change the game's momentum. Back to you.
What do you think, Bob?
Okay. Good move. Good move. Smart.
On
DVD Tuesday, October 16th. Our future is in his hands.
You hold the key to Earth's survival.
No!
Transformers. Be the first to own it on DVD and HD DVD Tuesday, October 16th.
We're going to third period action from February 22nd, 1958, and a point of interest is to keep an eye open for a young Bob Nevin and a young Carl Brewer, who are going to be playing in their first shifts in the National Hockey League in this third period as they've been brought up from junior hockey. Let's go upstairs now to the gondola, and here's Foster Hewitt.
Here the Leafs come in on right off the bat, and Hall pulled off a great save there right from the drop of the hat. Rangers lead Canadians 2-1. Worsley was hit in the face with a puck, and the game was delayed there in Montreal. Now all ready for the faceoff here. It's a 1-1 tie and an extremely important game. Here's Mahovlich and Thompson going through a few threatening gestures. Doesn't appear to be any love lost between these two clubs. They're on even terms in points and in the standing and on the game, one apiece. Morrison gets that puck over to Stewart. Stewart took his shot and hit Kushinen. Litzenberger starting out and shooting it down the ice. Don't forget, the Hawks have two men on the penalty box and the Leafs one. So they're playing 4-5. The Leafs having the advantage in manpower. Here's Mahovlich getting a clear path in on the left wing. He shoots, he scores! He picked the top corner with a drive. Mahovlich. That was a terrific shot. A regular Charlie Conacher windup on that one. And that gives the Leafs the lead for the second time in the game. And Mahovlich let that go. It just blistered into the top corner. Hall had little or no chance on it. He didn't even see it. He made a last moment try for it. That's in the first minute of the third period. And Mahovlich. Morrison gets the assist. 35 seconds is the scoring play for the Leafs. Mahovlich has been coming awfully close during this game tonight. Finally did collect with a terrific shot. That makes it 2-1 for the Maple Leafs. Stewart clearing it out. And of course, now the sides are even, 5 apiece. With Morrison and Pulford sitting them out, they've got double minors. Pilat, of course, returned on that scoring play by Mahovlich to the Leafs. That was Mahovlich's 19th goal. Puck is in the lead zone. It's James. That's going back to the net, flipping over to Morrison, who's trying to come out. Morrison shot to the open wing. James carries up. They're 5 aside. Stewart is at center ice, clearing over to Morrison, number 3. Long shot at Hall, and Vasco clears it back of the net. There's Moose. See how big he is, 22. He towers over the others. Here's Stewart getting a shot that's knocked down by Pilat. Pilat is away on the right wing. Vasco's with him. A pass on the side and a shot by Murphy was stopped by Chadwick. But Alcorn, failing to get out, gets out the second time. Over to James. James stopped. Murphy went after him and Nestorenko gets the pass. There's Nestorenko at center ice for the Hawks. Canesta's way by into the corner. Stewart beat him to the puck. A clearing pass to James is shot back and it went wide of the Leafs net when Vasco let a long shot go. Puck is still in the league zone. Morrison going back to his own net. The Maple Leafs lead 2-1. A clearing pass to center goes into the Chicago zone. That's Vasco, 22. And then the Hawks with Nestorenko, who's played a good game, to Murphy. Murphy got a shot at Chadwick, who steered it to the corner. From the left wing, Masnik is blocked. Pilat takes his shot. Chadwick knocks it down, and Barry Cullen is trying to come out. He stopped. Bond ahead to Masnik. Masnik up to Pulford, who's going on in there, back on the ice, Pulford and Mortson. Puck is at center. The team's at full strength. Clearing pass at center. Pilat takes it over the line. Masnik goes after it. Skov gets it to Nestorenko, and the shot went wide, and there's Rayom trying to pull out away on the left wing. He's bounced and hurt on the play, but gets up slowly. Going to carry on, though. It's Skov lobbing it into the lead zone, and the Blackhawks are trying to put the pressure on. Nestorenko broke up the first rush by Bond. Left there, Nestorenko centers it out, and it's missed. And it goes right down the ice. Mortson coming over to get it. That's Mortson number two. He and Pulford together again. Mortson chased back into the corner. Clearing out. Not enough. Pulford gets ready and shot wide when checked. Masnik gets that puck to Barry Cullen. And it's Nestorenko recovering. Three-man break for the Hawks. Cleared on into the corner. Up the Leaf goal, and Cullen was knocked flat by Nestorenko and hurt. Barry Cullen was given a jolt by Nestorenko and knocked flat. That's Barry Cullen lying on the ice after getting the shoulder from Nestorenko, and Bond goes over to speak to Nestorenko, and Nestorenko pulled his stick down. Nestorenko goes to see Cullen, who apparently is... He had an injured shoulder, and this may have completed the injury. He's still lying face down. Nestorenko is skating over towards the bench. Looks like they'll have to have a stretcher to take Cullen. It's moving the seats away. He's up on his feet, though. But he seems to be really out on his feet. That's Barry Cullen. They're assisting him. Smitty, the trainer, is assisting him along with Morrison. Score is 2-1 for the Maple Leafs in an extremely rugged game, and Barry Cullen is going to the dressing room now. Masnik will face off with Hull. Certainly playing this one for keeps. There's Vaughn on the right side. Mortson missed him. Then Nevin goes into the corner. He's the Marlboro Jr. Here's back to Vaughn. Vaughn shoots, bounces off the leg into the crowd.
Rib Rages is back at Boston Pizza with a classic rib dinner and chicken and ribs, both with garlic toast, Caesar salad, and side dish for just $16.95. Boston Pizza, you're among friends.
Grammy Award winners and international superstars Maroon 5 are back, and just in time for the summer heat. Their highly anticipated follow-up album, It Won't Be Soon Before Long, includes the smash single, Makes Me Wonder. Five's hot new CD available at Best Buy and online at bestbuy.ca.
Better hurry if we're going to make that show.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Maybe you guys should go on ahead without us.
You sure?
Yeah, we'll catch up.
How did you know which wire to disconnect?
Ask your doctor if Cialis is right for you.
2-1 here for the Leafs. Mihaljevic and Armstrong coming out with Horton. And here's the other junior from Marlboro's coming on the ice for the first time tonight, Carl Brewer. Brewer, number 25. He's on the defense for the first time tonight. This is his second game in NHL company. He played in Detroit. Now Litzenberger cleared into the corner, and the two Chicago players fell and knocked each other over, and it looks like a Leaf penalty as a result, as the two Chicago players went sliding into each other, and Horton gets the gate for upsetting the Chicago player. He seemed to interfere in the play, and he knocked one of them flying, and he fell into the other Chicago player. So it'll be Horton likely for interference. And looks like 4:30. Yes, interference. 4:30 is the time. And now the Chicago Blackhawks will have an opportunity with the man advantage. James is coming out on the ice. The defense has been changed so that they have Stewart and Morrison with James and Alcorn trying to kill off this penalty. Howell is out there for Chicago, ready for the face-off. Alcorn got it back, and Pilot getting the shot wide. The puck is out in front. Pilot at the Leaf blue line, scooped it into the corner. Litzenberger has watched. Stewart knocked it over to Alcorn. Alcorn failed to clear it out, a race for the puck. Morrison got down to splash the puck down the ice. Vasco back for it, watched by James. There's Vasco. Good shot close to the net there as Hull fell, and James fell over. There's James chasing him. The Hawks come back with Litzenberger over the line. A pass just behind the Chicago player who was closing in, Ferguson. Back comes Alcorn for the Leafs with James, dragging the puck back to Morrison. There's Morrison taking his time, shooting it away. It's in the Chicago zone. They've played 5.5 minutes of the third period. 1 minute left now in Horton's penalty. Hull is leading a rush, four of them up. Pass on the left wing. Ferguson's knocked off stride. James goes back to the net. Litzenberger trying to center out. Morrison goes back to the net. The corner shot it, but not out. Vasco drove one wide. Stewart lifted a high one. Pilot knocked it down with a high stick. And the referee orders the face-off, brought right back. The referee is Lou Ferrelli, having a hard game to handle and doing a good job. Matt Pavlich and George Hayes are the two linesmen. Score is 2-1 for the Maple Leafs. 1-0 into the first, 1-1 into the second. And they have 34 seconds left in the penalty to Horton, as you see by the penalty clock, which is at the north end of the gardens to our left. And the Chicago end there. That's the Hawks on the move. Here's Stove at center. A bouncing shot. Chadwick caught it, tipped it back to Pulford. Pulford with Masnik now. Stewart and Morrison, they fail to get it out. Murphy wiggling, gets it back to Vasco. A shot, and it went wide of the net. Here's another scoop that Skov failed to get. Pilot gets it over to Vasco. Vasco shoots. It hit Murphy. Masnik getting away to center ice. Going up over the line. Horton's on the ice. Into the corner. Horton's in on the play. And the teams are at full strength. Murphy starts Vasco on the move at center ice with Nestorenko. Vasco keeps on going. A shot is caught by Chadwick. And Nestorenko went sifting by him from close quarters. On the faceoff, the puck rolls to the side. Braun tried to scoop it. Martin took his shot. It's wide. And it's Mahovlich coming down to center ice. Armstrong trailing. Mahovlich into the corner, 27. Get a close-up there as he tried to move from the side. Horton gets in on the play. Back to Morrison, a shot. Hull caught it. There's Morrison back of the net. Horton broke up that pass. Horton is moving in now for the Leafs. Right in, a goal! And Hull made a beautiful save there. They're right in front again. A shot went wide. centered out in front again, and Nestorenko gets a break. Down the right wing, a pass on the left side, missed by Murphy. Nestorenko's knocked flat by Armstrong. They're pouring in there as Mihaljevic tears right in a goal and was held by Thompson. There'll be a penalty here against Thompson of the Chicago Blackhawks. Here they come to the penalty box. Stove is watching. Thompson is the one that gets the call. He's going in the penalty box. Number five. He had the Leaf player well hooked on the play. So they have about 12 minutes and 16 seconds left in the game. 2-1 for the Maple Leaf.
Thompson, 7:45
is the time of the hooking penalty to Thompson. Rangers and Montreal are now tied 2-2 at the end of the second period. That's in Montreal. 2-1 here for the Leafs. Goals by Pulford and Mihaljevic. Litzenberger for the Blackhawks. Harris now at center ice for the Leafs. Kushinen shot it off the boards. The Leafs have the odd man, and Brewer is on the Leaf defense with Stewart. Brewer is 25. Stewart gets it over to Brewer. That's Brewer there, the youngster from the Marlboro Juniors. A clearing pass. Brewer is on the move now at center ice. Took a long shot. Hall caught it. Pilot from the corner is well checked by Alcorn. Skov gets into it too. They're all jamming around with James starting to shove Pilot there. There's a real close-up. Almost in your living room.
Hey, nice robot.
Yeah, but it's got some bugs.
Gigabyte me.
See? So I need a really powerful laptop.
Nerd.
Sure. Well, this one has a dual-core processor, which is a lot faster than previous generation.
Techno-dork. Mega-geek.
I'm really sorry.
It's okay. It also comes with 2 gigs of RAM.
RAM lover.
Which allows you to run multiple applications at the same time.
Great.
He'll take it, dork stick.
Wendy's Junior Bacon Cheeseburger is made with fresh, never frozen beef. And the combo comes with a drink and your choice of sides, like a baked potato, slow-cooked chili, or side salad for just $3.99 every day. Wendy's, that's right.
NHL 2K8 features full 360-degree puck control and authentic signature style for an all-new video game experience.
Hey, Spez, how's the new goaltending system?
Goalies.
NHL 2K8, rated everyone 10 and up.
Face off. Stewart couldn't keep that puck in. It went off his stick. He's clearing it over on the left wing to Brewer. Brewer gets tangled up but shot it over the line. James tried to gallop in there but fell. Then Kushinen starts out from the corner for Chicago. Lobbed it out to center ice where Harris is on the move, leaving it for Alcorn. Alcorn cuts over on the right wing. Ran into the Chicago player, bowled him over from the corner. It goes back to Stewart. Here's his shot right on. Harris tried to tap it in and missed, and the Hawks shoot it down the ice. And that's Brewer going back for the puck, 25. He waited, left it there. The Hawks broke up the first Leaf rush. Litzenberger checked by Harris. Harris gets by Kushinen, centered out, and Kushinen goes right in front of his own net, clearing it off the boards, down the ice. Brewer going back for it again. Cullen is back on the ice. That's Barry Cullen, who was injured. Litzenberger broke up the Leaf rush. Brewer gets that puck again. His pass goes over the line to center ice. Masnik knocked it back into the Chicago zone. Masnik in back to the Chicago goal. Beat Pilot to it. Pulford center, right in front to Cullen, a shot and Hall. Got in front beautifully to cover up. Cullen had a direct shot at the net, but Hall wasn't to be moved out of position. Made a great play on it. So the face-off to the right of the Chicago goal. 10 minutes and 14 seconds remaining. 2-1 for the Leafs. And the tightest kind of a game. Masnik facing off with Hall. Litzenberger is on the rim of the circle. Here's Pulford trying to get his shot. He couldn't. Litzenberger back to Thompson, ahead to Hall. Hall is on the move now for Chicago. 16. Got it over the line. Left a drop pass. Litzenberger missed the pass. And the Leafs lost it again as Mortson broke up a Leaf rush. Here's Litzenberger back to the Leaf goal. And it's shot by Mortson wide. Hull is right in front of the net as they're whacking at it. A scramble in front of the goal. And everybody's trying to cover up. Then Hull shoves Pulford. Litzenberger gets in there too. And that may be something. You can see how it can develop there as they all jam in against that glass. That's Ferguson 11 that was there. Morrison 3, Pulford 20. And Pulford has been in on almost everything tonight. He was the one that was in with Mortson in a two-rounder. One that first round was on the ice, the second round was in the corridor. And then the puck is recovered by Horton, going down with Mahovlich. Horton goes over the line. His shot is high. Mahovlich tried to center. Thompson had him covered. Armstrong centered out in front, and Baum slapped it. Mortson cleared it out to center ice to Litzenberger. Litzenberger going up over the line. Armstrong in ahead of Hull. Horton back to the net. Here's a fight with Hull and Armstrong. There they go. Litzenberger trying to hold them off. They're all piling up. Just one series of mix-ups in this game. You can see how they all get inside the screen with plenty to spare. Guess we'll have to move your set from the living room into the rumpus room. There's Ferguson there, ready to do battle. He's on the fringe. Now you see how they're pulling them apart. There's the big chief, Armstrong, being forced back into the corner. The photographer is trying to get a close-up, and every time he does, they all crowd in front of him. They're all concentrated in that small area, with the exception of the two goalkeepers. Now there they might start again. You can never tell. You can see what a time the referee has as he's just skating around on the fringe just to see what's going on generally. That's Horton picking up his stick. Now they're all trying to find their sticks and gloves. They're all over the place. That's Bond, who isn't anxious to pick up his stick yet. Now he's starting to look around. That's Bond 21. You see the C on Armstrong's sweater. They're tan. He's going around, still looking for his gloves. He's got one of them. Now we'll see how they're going to assess penalties as a result of that one. It was 1-0 to the Leafs, end of the first. A 1-1 tie, end of the second. Mahovlich scored in 35 seconds to give the Leafs the lead from Morrison. Hull is in the penalty box. Armstrong is going in with them. Hull and Armstrong off together. And the time is 10:46.
Chicago penalty, foul. 5 minutes for fight. Leaf penalty, Armstrong, 5 minutes for fight. Time, 10:46.
That's two majors for fighting. So they carry a fine with them, too. Hull and Armstrong off for 5 minutes, majors for fighting. The time is 10:46. And now the teams will be five aside. It's 2-1 for the Leafs. And they have 9 minutes and 14 seconds left in the game. And they're all set. And then Vasco holds up the game while he comes over the boards, replacing Thompson. Litzenberger and Ferguson on the forward line. Vasco is checked and knocked down by James, who's really throwing his weight around tonight. Added a lot of spark to this Leaf team. Stewart from the corner shoots it out to center ice. Mortson missed it and goes back for it. That's Mortson there. Being watched by Alcorn. He breaks loose, though, tearing up the ice with Ferguson. And Stewart broke it up, passing to Alcorn. Alcorn alone going in on Vasco, right in. Oh, beautiful save by Hall. And Alcorn made Vasco look rather weak on that one. Here's a rolling puck in front of the Chicago net, and Alcorn was knocked over. Litzenberger coming up with a rush, ran into a stone wall, and James got the loose puck, lobbed it ahead to Alcorn. James going up for the pass, takes it, going in on the left side from the corner, back to the net, and shot wide of the corner. Nestorenko now out there for Chicago. They're five aside. Here comes Nestorenko at center. Over the Leaf line, moving in very fast, back of the net. Cleared it back to Vasco. His pass to Pilot went off the stick. And it's Morrison into the corner, lobbing one to the opposite side. Stewart going after it. Stewart with Barry Cullen and Pulford. Puck rolls to one side of the Chicago net. Barry Cullen back to Morrison. Morrison getting ready with a shot right on. Hall made a nice stop, and Vasco went to the corner. Quick pass to Murphy, back to Nestorenko. Nestorenko's been one of the Hawks' most dangerous players. Morrison upset him, and will get a penalty for tripping. Morrison upset Nestorenko.
Let's take a look. This is what I was afraid of.
Here's another one.
They're everywhere. Yep, you got bankers. Switch to Capital One to get rid of them.
With their high-interest credit cards, banks can be a pest. Find out what we can offer you at CapitalOne.ca.
What's in your wallet?
Wendy's delicious five-piece chicken nuggets combo comes with a drink and your choice of sides, like a baked potato, slow-cooked chili, or side salad for just $3.99 every day. Wendy's, that's right.
Around here, there's no shortage of tradition. It's seemingly passed from one generation to another. Take True Canadian Taste, a perfect balance of real flavor and refreshing taste. Apparently, it's all part of the ritual.
Speaking of rituals, I hear there's no end to the pranks these guys play.
Hey guys, who are we pranking first? I want to get my prank on.
There's only one true Canadian taste, Molson Canadian Lager.
Do you want to practice like a Leaf? Your team can win a chance to experience an on-ice coaching session, the Leafs practice from the bench, and a tour of the Maple Leafs dressing room. Log on to MapleLeafs.com and enter your Danone product UPC code. Practice like a Leaf.
Now the Leafs will be two men short and Chicago one. There's Morrison, rather disgusted. Tripping penalty, and the time is 12:33. Apparently, someone threw an egg on the ice, which is rather unusual for here. Two to one is the score, and the Hawks have a great chance now as the Leafs are two men short and the Hawks one. So the Chicago team have a one-man advantage. The Leafs cleared to center. Cushenham gets ready over the line, passing to Murphy. Murphy from the corner is trying to center it out. Coming out in front, back to Pilot. Pilot still has it, took his shot. Stewart stopped it. Stewart tried to clear it, didn't. And Murphy gets that puck back to the net. Rayom sticks with him, knocked him over, and it's Mazdik back to the Leaf goal. Is upset. There'll be a penalty there to Nestorenko for hooking. Mazdik is going back at Nestorenko. But Nestorenko will certainly get the penalty there. But he nearly drew Mazdik into it too when Mazdik went back at him. And here's the call on Nestorenko. He seems to be in disfavor at the moment because of the episode with Barry Cohen. However, Nestorenko has been playing a great game. There he is, 15. And now you can see how that bench is crowded with less than 7 minutes remaining. Now they're ready to go, and they'll play four aside now. So the sides are even. Pilat cleared, and Raum shot it off the boards. Pilat gives it to Litzenberger. He's out there with Murphy. Litzenberger at center ice. Left the puck there. Then Murphy tries to go in. Moving in fast. Still has it. Still has that puck. Gets it over to Pilat. Pilat gets it back to Murphy. Here's right in front of the net. And Chadwick stops Litzenberger from close quarters as the Hawks put on a real nifty there. Mazdik getting out on the right wing. One man back. Pilat. Mazdik, no hurry though. Cuts back. Falls. Still keeps the puck in there. 2-1 for the Leafs with Litzenberger feeding a long pass to Pilat. Pilat at center. Right back to Litzenberger. He's trying to get in position. Mazdik knocked the puck off the boards to center. Pilat going back for it, and they're very cagey. Less than 6 minutes remaining in the game. Pilat, 21 for Chicago. There's a clearing pass to Skov, who stepped on the ice. Mazdik gets that puck, knocked it out to center. Murphy was calling for relief, but has to take part in the play. And now Skov gets it over to Pilat. Pilat is stopped by Raum. Skov chased into the corner by Mazdik. They jam against the boards. And Morrison is on the ice. He was just tearing in there to get on the ice. But the whistle blew at the same time. 5 minutes and 25 seconds remaining. 2-1 for the Leafs. And now the Leafs have the odd man advantage, as the Blackhawks are playing four men to five. Nestorenko and Hall in the box. Armstrong for the Leafs. Hall and Armstrong are the two that received the major penalties. Nestorenko only has about 28 seconds of his penalty left. Puck goes into the corner, and Barry Cohen is taking his time. Back of the net. Horton is the other forward with Pulford and Stewart. Stewart is coasting in front. A clearing pass goes right down the ice. Mortson is going after it. There he is. And it's called for icing against the Leafs. Play is brought right back into the Maple Leaf zone. The Leafs go to New York for a very important game tomorrow night. In fact, every game they play is important. The same applies to Chicago and Boston. Taking their time on this face-off. The Hawks haven't decided who they'll have stay out there, but Skov is going to stay there with Mortson and Thompson now. Pulford is facing off for the Leafs. Over to Cullen. Cullen on the move. There he is at center ice. He's right in on goal. He shoots. Hall made a great save, and Skov cleared that rebound and took it to the corner. Now the Nestorenko's on the ice. Just came out there, and now the teams are five aside. Less than 4 minutes remaining, or rather 5 minutes. 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Rangers and Canadians tied 2-2 in Montreal in the last period. They're waiting as Horton goes to the bench. Mahovlich is now going back too. You see him going to the bench. Had too many men on the ice. And Pulford is going to be out there with Barry Cohen, Morrison, and Stewart. flip pass to Nestoranko, back to Thompson. Thompson shoots it over on the far wing to Mortson. Mortson pulling away now. Passed on the left wing. It's Skov moving to center ice. Took a bouncing shot. Chadwick played it back of the net. Morrison knocked it to the corner. Nestoranko left it there for Skov. Skov centers it and Pulford intercepts. Two men trying to get back as Pulford goes up. Stewart trailing. Hall knocked a low shot down. Pulford has been playing a strong game for the Leafs tonight. Very aggressive. And there's Nestoranko coasting down the left wing. He goes on in the corner. Armstrong and Hall are back on the ice. The team's at full strength for a change. Quick pass on the left wing. Thompson broke it up. Armstrong and Nestoranko start bumping one another. Armstrong is watched by Nestoranko in that corner. Puck is loose. The Skov covering. Stewart was beside him. That was Cullen just getting up.
I've been saying some controversial things about Molson Canadian. I've asked about this alleged true Canadian taste and wondered if it's brewed by Canada's oldest brewery. Does that really matter? Now, overall, people haven't reacted well, but the people here have treated me with respect and admiration.
Thank you, Alberta!
Thank you! I've enjoyed your meat!
There's only one true Canadian taste, Molson Canadian Lager.
Want proof that Polaris makes the world ATVs? Take the all-new Sportsman X2 800. 800 cc's of muscle, electronic fuel injection, a dumping cargo box. Tough, tough, tough. But what makes the Sportsman X2 twice as tough for the competition to beat is that it changes from a one-up to a two-up ride anytime, anywhere, without any screwing around. Sportsman X2 800 from Polaris, the world's toughest ATV.
Here later. The Prestidigitizer. We need you to get all kinds of shipments to all kinds of places.
Purelator's size lets you customize so people can get prestidigitized.
Customize.
Let's get started.
When you ship with Purelator, out of the ordinary is never out of the question. Purelator, where business is going.
Alan Litzenberger getting ready with Armstrong. Puck comes over to Pilot. Here's a shot, and it's wide. Horton on the right wing, trying to get that puck out. He does. Mahovlich on the left wing, goes up, gets that puck, and just couldn't get by Pilot, who wrestled with him into the corner. Armstrong stopped Hull. Now Vasco is stopped by Mahovlich. Litzenberger is pinned against the boards by Armstrong. Mahovlich passed behind Horton. There's Armstrong after it with Vasco on his back, and Hall grabbed that puck momentarily with Hall being stopped. They jamming into the corner. Lots of holding going on there, as you notice. Here comes Pilot up at center ice. Ferguson with them. They shoot it off the boards, and Stewart goes back to the Leaf goal. A quick pass, stopped by Litzenberger. Here's a shot wide. Less than 3 minutes. Vasco took his shot. Stewart knocked it down. Stewart is coming out on the right wing for the Leafs with Mahovlich tearing in for the rebound. He's right in and shot wide. The Hawks on the move. Ferguson carrying up the center ice. Three of them going up over the line. Litzenberger gets the pass, took his shot, and Chadwick caught that one and held it long enough for a face-off. 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in the game. 2-1 for the Toronto Maple Leafs over the Chicago Blackhawks. Rangers and Canadians tied 2-2 in the last period at Montreal. Complete change of players. That's Barry Cullen there, followed by Pulford, 20. Masnik is at center with Alcorn and James. Skov at center for Chicago, Nestoranko and Murphy. Loose, the Hawks get it. Nestoranko into the corner, tried to center it. It's knocked back to the net, and Masnik shoots it off the boards. Mortson slaps it right back. They jam in there to cover. The puck is loose to Masnik. Masnik with Alcorn from the corner. Nestorenko cruises in to get it back to Thompson. Here's a shot, and it's stopped by Morrison, who cleared it out. Mazda goes to center ice, and Mortson recovered the puck. Mortson is knocked over by Morrison. Then Thompson shoots it down the ice. Stewart shoots it right back again. And it's going into the Chicago zone. Mortson touches it. And the Leafs are called for icing the puck. Brought back for a very important face-off in the Maple Leaf zone to the right. Masnik and Skov facing off. James got it momentarily. It goes loose again. Morrison into the corner, back of the net. Knocked it to the opposite corner, cleared it down the ice. It's going right on down. Thompson and Alcorn race for it. Thompson beat the Leaf player, and that means the Leafs are called, and Hall is going out of the net with a minute and 25 seconds. So they're going to gamble everything. Hall is out of the net. He's going to get in there for a sixth forward. And the Chicago team will have six attackers inside the Leaf blue line with a minute and 25 seconds left. The Chicago net is absolutely empty. The Leafs are taking their time talking this one over. The Hawks desperate to tie it up now. Here the puck is dropped. It goes to Hall. A shot right on. And Chadwick grabbed that one. Hall let a quick shot go. And Chadwick was very alert on that. A minute and 22 seconds remaining in the game. You see by the clock there. More changes being made. Hall is still in the on the bench. Chicago net is empty. Litzenberger will face off with Armstrong. He's out there with Mahovlich and Barry Cullen. Barry Cullen gets that puck, flipped it to Mahovlich. Here he's coming in on the empty net. He shoots and scores! Mahovlich puts the game on ice. Mahovlich getting his second goal, firing it into the open net. And that effort of taking a goalkeeper out is boomeranged on the Blackhawks. Mahovlich scoring his 20th goal of the season. That's two possessions from Mahovlich. And they have a minute and 12 seconds. 18:48 is the time of that breakaway with Barry Cullen assisting. He cleared it ahead to Mahovlich. And Mahovlich got the opening. Chicago defenseman was trying to cover him, but he fired it from well out, about 40 or 50 feet into the open net. Now Hall is back in goal. 3-1 for the Leafs. And the Leafs move again with Rayom clearing into the corner. 1 minute left.
Leafs goal scored by Mahovlich. Assist, Barry Cullen and Armstrong.
Armstrong also got an assist.
18:48.
Mahovlich from Barry Cullen and Armstrong. Puck is in the Chicago zone. It's Hall moving to the attack. Stopped at center ice. Mahovlich coming back again. Here he goes to the defense. He's knocked over by Pilat. Litzenberger is bumped. Taken by Armstrong. Armstrong cleared to Bond. Bond going in with a shot, and Vasco stopped at 21 seconds left. Vasco passed on the wing to Hall, who failed to get out. It shot to center, and Bond broke it up. The Leafs are watching every move of the Hawks as Litzenberger attacked, and Armstrong gets that puck, left it there. Here's Hull going in and knocked over. Back goes Mahovlich. And there's going to be a cross-checking penalty to the Leafs with 3 seconds left. There are all kinds of action. Armstrong will get it. Cross-checking penalty to Armstrong, number 10. He only has 3 seconds, though, to set it out. 1957. And the Leafs will be a man short for 3 seconds, approximately. 3-1 is the score. There, Barry Cullen is back of the net. And the game is over.
This is Quiznos Beef and Swiss Melt on Garlic Bread, one of the many options available at Quiznos for dinner. Butcher quality seasoned roast beef, real Swiss cheese and mushrooms on garlic bread. Do you need a moment to wipe the drool from your chin?
Quiznos, a cut above.
Want proof that Polaris makes the world's toughest ATVs? Take the all-new Sportsman X2 800. 800 cc's of muscle, electronic fuel injection, a dumping cargo box. Tough, tough, tough. But what makes the Sportsman X2 twice as tough for the competition to beat is that it changes from a one-up to a two-up ride anytime, anywhere, without any screwing around. Sportsman X2 800 from Polaris, the world's toughest ATVs.
Do you want to practice like a Leaf? Your team can win a chance to experience a coaching session, the Leafs practice from the bench, and a tour of the Maple Leafs dressing room. Log on to MapleLeafs.com and enter your Denon product UPC code. Practice like a Leaf.
I'm Joanne Roberts, and I'm a piano teacher. A rock had chipped my windshield, and it had spread right across the driver's side.
Did you know you had a crack in your windshield?
Oh. Apple Autoglass took care of everything. They certainly know what they're doing.
And now's the perfect time to visit your local Apple Autoglass during the Fix It and Win sweepstakes. You could win a sunny getaway trip for two, or a flat-screen TV, or $2,500 in cash. Plus, scratch for your chance to win instant prizes. Come in for your chance to win.
Canada's local auto glass experts.
The Maple Leafs get a pair of goals from future Calder Trophy winner Frank Mahovlich, as his first at 35 seconds from Jim Morrison made it 2-1 Toronto, and then his 20th from Barry Cullen and George Armstrong at 18:48 rounds out the scoring as the Leafs beat the Blackhawks by a score of 3-1. You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
Let's take a look. This is what I was afraid of.
Here's another one.
Oh, they're everywhere. Yep, you got Bankers. Switch to Capital One to get rid of them.
With their high-interest credit cards, banks can be a real pest. Find out what we can offer you at CapitalOne.ca.
What's in your wallet?
Hey.
Hey.
All drive?
Nah, we'll switch when we need gas.
Surprisingly fuel-efficient Dodge Caliber.
More life in the globe.
February 1958, Gus, your career goes on. You end up later on being dealt to Detroit a little bit. Tell us about the how it came to an end.
How it came to an end.
But the years in Detroit, what were they like?
Well, I never got around to play much at training camp. When I started off, I had the misfortune of getting the ligaments in my left knee pulled, and I really didn't get back into shape again until well into the following year in February before mm-hmm. Jack Adams, he called me in and he says, look, we want to send you down to, I forget where it was, the American League, and get in shape. He said, back. And I says, well, look, I says, instead of sending me down there, I says, why don't you sell me to Buffalo, and at least I can commute then from Toronto to Buffalo and back. It won't, not that far. So that's what he did. Buffalo team phoned me up and says, would you come if we get you? And so they had to, what they did was they got New York to pick me up on draft, and I guess they paid the shot, the Buffalo team, and I went to Buffalo, and I played in Buffalo then for the balance of that year, plus the next year.
And
then I said, it's about time I retired.
Well, we want to thank you for coming down from Timmins to join us, because I know it's a bit of a drive, to be sure. What are you up to in that neck of the woods these days?
Well, all I do now is I golf 5 days a week.
And you're a scratch golfer probably now, are
you? No, but I'm getting better.
Good for you. And enjoy it up there in God's country. And I know yes. You're also going to be a prominent part of the new Hall of Fame that's going on up there for Northeastern Ontario players who were apparently played in the National Hockey League, and I've read about that. So
it's going to be quite a building.
In New Liskeard, is it not?
No, it's in Kirkland Lake, and they're including players from as far south as Sundridge, I believe. Sundridge is the south end, mm-hmm. and they're also going as far as somewhere between Nipigon, I believe. Lake mm-hmm. Nipigon, okay. I don't believe they're getting the players from Northwestern.
And Thunder Bay and that area.
Yeah, in that area.
Northeastern Ontario.
Yeah.
And that's great. And you'll have a significant spot in that hole, I'm sure. We want to thank you very, very much for dropping down and visiting us.
Well, I've enjoyed it. It's been
great.
Very good.
Well, we've taken Gus Mortson along with you back to a couple of games from the 1957-58 season. We want to thank him for